चलो
करेंगे
डायरेक्ट
चल रहे, डायरेक्ट चल रहे।
ओके यस सर। सर गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। सर द सेशन इज ऑन द ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग, वन डे ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग सेशंस ऑन ई ऑफिस एंड पेपरलेस ऑफिस सर। इनिशियली सर आई वेलकम ऑल द डिग्निटरीज, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर डॉक्टर एच डी सावंत जी, डॉक्टर भावे सर, डायरेक्टर ऑफ एक्सटेंशन एजुकेशन, डायरेक्टर ऑफ रिसर्च डॉक्टर पराग हरदनकर जी, डायरेक्टर ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन डॉक्टर सतीश नारखेड़े जी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑल ऑफिसर सर। सर टुडे द गेस्ट स्पीकर डॉक्टर गर्जे सर इज अ डेप्युटी डायरेक्टर फ्रॉम एनआईसी सर। ही विल स्पीकिंग द डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशन सर। ही इज अ मैन सर बिहाइंड द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग ऑफ द ई ऑफिस इन द ऑल गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गनाइजेशन एंड इज स्पेशल कोऑर्डिनेटर टू द महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट सर। सेकंड स्पीकर सर डॉक्टर आर सी गोयल सर इज अ रिटायर्ड प्रोफेसर इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर स्टेटिस्टिकल रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट सर एंड ऑल द आईसीटी इनिशिएटिव इन द ICR and State Agriculture University, sir. Third speaker is sir Dr. Sandeep Patil ji, sir. He is on the specially the audit objection, because number of times sir the query is arise in your mind. So e-office, then what is the audit problem solved? So he will speak sir in the prescriptive. Next speaker is sir Sudeep Marawaji. He is the head department Indian Agriculture Statistical Research Institute, sir, and now initiating all the ICT activity in ICR. Next speaker is sir Dr. Alka Arora ji. He is the principal scientist and working with the team with Dr. Sudeep Marawaji sir. Next speaker is Mr. Manoj sir. He is working sir implementing the e offices in the consumer forum. He is also joined sir. Sir, I request Bhave sir sir to remarks on this program. Bhave sir, please.
Good morning, everybody. Could you listen to me?
Yeah. Boli, boli.
Yes, sir.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. Director Research, Dr. Hardankar, Dr. Narkhede, all dignitaries, particularly the guest speakers, and all my colleagues, those who are attending this. Thank you very much for, thank you very much, Dr. Kolle, for organizing this kind of very good informative brainstorming session. It's really a matter of today. And this is the time when we think of e-office and other things. I know it is very, I know some problems will be there. And when we introduce a new system, there will be problem, both for adopting and acclimatizing a new system. But once it is acclimatized well, I think it is very good system for us, particularly e-office is concerned. Now, for having a more techno-saviness and particularly data, the storage and other thing, I think this is most important. Transparency is also concerned. It is also important. Only the thing is that how we see when we introduce the computer in India, same thing happened earlier. Now the same thing is there when we try to implement e-communication thing.
Yeah, offline game. गाड़ी तो अपनी गाड़ी कुछ तो जिधर चल रही थी तब ऊपर आओ मनो एक आटिक।
भावी सर इंतज़ार माइक में उड़ जाना है।
अनम्यूट करा, अनम्यूट डॉक्टर भावे साहब, अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, यू गॉट म्यूटेड।
सर ऑनरेबल व्हीसी सर मे बी इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी सर हाय सर मे बी डिसकनेक्टेड सर
You go ahead with
sir, I request sir to honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. S. D. Savanji sir for the opening remarks on this program, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Kole sir. I welcome here for this particular webinar on e-office or implementation of e-office, probable implementation in our university. Mr. Lakshmikant Garje Saab, you had come over here some time back and you have already given NIC's softwares and related benefits. One small half a day almost you spent with us and discussed. So we are aware about little bit about your system. So welcome you. We hope that you will give us still more insight on the possibility of implementation of e-office in our system. ICR's Dr. R.C. Goyal Saab is there. Has he joined?
No, sir. He will join later, sir. Yes.
Okay. I am seeing Sandeep Patil on the line, probably. Or Sudeep Marwaji. We have been colleague in ICR long back, and I know that your agency was main agency to implement e-office and similar systems in ICR. And we expect particularly in university system, research extension programs, we have to be in tune with what rest of the country is doing. And then you have developed certain systems which help us in monitoring research programs and other things. So I hope that you will give us some good idea about this system. And e-office in extension, Dr. Alka Arora ji yahan pe hai. Welcome, madam. We expect you to give us some good insight on our extension systems. We hope, look forward to it. Then Mr. Manoj, around here?
Yes, sir. He was already joined, sir. But maybe... yes, sir.
Mr. Manoj, I have been hearing you all the time or telephone several times. I'm seeing you first time face to face. And I wish that you will be there with us continuously because since your talk is at the end, we would like you to summarize many things given by information given by other speakers. And we look forward to you do good. Today's program, we are basically organizing because in our universities, still we are not using computer to the maximum. I think even the junior clerk to director level, everybody has his own computer. And we have a very good internet system, even though possibly we are remotely placed locationally. The internet connectivity in our area is quite good. And we are well connected with the internet. But most of the situations, computers are not being used more than typewriters. Then every computer is connected with a printer. And for every now and then, without requirement or with requirement, most of the people tend to take printouts of the things. We are very concerned about it. We don't want paper or printers to be used so often. Implementation of different programs, software related to our office work, we should be minimizing or completely stopping the use of paper, particularly habit of taking prints very often. We should be completely stopping that kind of a situation. Another thing, our university has got five districts of jurisdiction. Those five districts of jurisdiction are placed in the total distance from the remotest and two places is about 600-700 kilometers. And files coming from those places for approval in our head office, there are many times physically the files have to come, which takes a longer time. But since the internet connections and computer availability is quite good, computer literacy is good among the our staff members, we should be introducing e-office in our system as early as possible. This is our personal feeling. One more thing, most of the time, why our e-office related softwares are less popular or they are not adopted very promptly in our system. The reason I find it are very peculiar. One thing is not replacing papers with soft copies. Everywhere we say that we have a soft copy. I mean, whether it is a purchase procedure, we want most of the time the quotations and so many other things in a hard copy, not in a soft copy. We have to replace that requirement in audit requirement. So that is one aspect. When the purchase procedures are there or any permissions are, any staff is seeking permissions, the files physically move one place to other place. And many places, the concerned officer doesn't want to record his comments directly. So in your software, there should be some provision. There should be a main note sheet and there should be a side note sheet where you ask some questions, you express your doubts and ask your subordinates to give an explanation on that before something can be concretely written on the note sheets. So, ye jo provisions hai, wo provisions software mein hona chahiye. Many times these provisions are there, but their files are not swiftly moved from one place to other place. Then, many of the softwares have tried to put transparency. From once you set the hierarchy, from which place to which place this file has to move. If you put the transparency that where and which place the file should remain for how much period of time. If the file is unnecessarily lying on one particular table for more than a certain period of time, it should automatically move further, or there should be a reminder alert coming out from the that particular location that the file is lying more period at this location. I mean, such type of intricacies softly and quickly happening in the software, then probably the e-office will move faster and it will work in official requirements appropriately. I mean, if this such type of provisions are there in your e-office with a little bit of transparency, then the softwares will work better. I mean, there are so many such practical aspects. Many of the times, our financing bodies or our government bodies require certain reports at the end of the year or in the end of any process. those reports should be automatically generated in a precisely in a format in which the government demands. We were trying to implement certain audit related or account related softwares in our university, and end of the day when the final reports were coming, they were in not tune with what Maharashtra government wants it. And then the issues came. Our people insisted to the software company, no, you should bring it out in the exact in that form where the government demands it. The software company says that whatever is demanded in directly or indirectly are there in those reports. So if I have to change the entire format, I require a lot of efforts to do that. So for quite some time, we have been struggling with the software company and the things are not being implemented. So we are not finalized. We have not yet finalized with the procedures. And we are still saying that this account software is not implemented. So end result should always give you the formats which the government or controlling body should are demanding from the university. Those kind of things should be taken care when before the software. I mean, how we should be ensuring that from the software producer supplying agency. Sometimes when any software is being implemented, from the beginning to end, it takes longer time. And when you come to end point, we realize that we are not getting the right output from the entire system. And then we are in trouble many times. So we wish to know how thus such things can be managed before implementing, because 2-3 years before our university thought of implementing some account software, still we are not finalized. So now today, if we are interested in implementing the e-office in our system, we don't want to come into a similar trap. We want to ensure that these small issues will be solved in the beginning only. So, I mean, these all so many such points are in our mind. And that's the reason why we have invited all the experts in the form of you all on the line here. I hope you people will give us proper guidance. What should be done before thinking of implementing e-office in the government system like university? See, to nutshell, I would say that university has major three divisions: education, extension, research. And all the three areas, we require certain amount of monitoring. That, I mean, apart from regular office procedures, we require monitoring also. So how that monitoring can be done through softwares, that is more important. And all the three wings are supported by different kind of administrative procedures. And if we have solutions for each of them, it will be interesting, and we will be very eager to adopt them for the benefit of the university and to improve our work efficiency and record keeping and other things. So I wish all those things will be discussed during our process of webinar throughout the day. And I will be there to listen to you all, and most of my colleagues, at least at associate dean level from all the colleges, would have joined this particular webinar. And we will be getting benefited through this webinar. Thank you very much. And all the best for all the speakers. Thank you.
Thank you, Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. Dr. Reddy Sawanji, sir. He has narrated all the requirements of the university, sir. Now, sir, I request Dr. Garje, sir, the expert domain in e-office, sir, and in the Maharashtra state, sir, to deliver your expert domain lecture. Yes, sir. गर्जे सर प्लीज.
थैंक यू वेरी मच कोले सर, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर सर, अदर डिग्निटरीज प्रेजेंट फॉर दिस प्रेजेंटेशन एज वेल एज द गेस्ट स्पीकर्स दोज हु आर कनेक्टेड थ्रू लॉन्ग आई कैन से फ्रॉम वेरियस प्लेसेस. I welcome all this also. First of all, I will thank to Vice Chancellor sir for giving me opportunity to talk about your office, and I am very fortunate that last time when I visited in my personal capacity to Dapoli, that time also the university asked me to give presentation with respect to this your office. I given that time also, and for that also I am thankful. Obviously also at that time I met today incidentally. Actually, their net is not connected. That's why we are unable to hear them. Anyway, thank you once again. I wanted to tell you that this e-office, most probably you people are knowing about it. See, in Maharashtra, this implementation is happening since 2012. But the application which it was envisaged in 2008 itself, the government wants that whatever happening in the organizations or in the offices, it should be transparent. So the main objective of this e-office is to bring transparency, speed definitely, and the accountability. All these three. Earlier what happened, people are working manually. Sometimes they are sending their files. Somewhere it is misplacing. Papers are coming to the offices. Papers are not going to the proper places. To avoid all these things, this has happened. For this office in Maharashtra, in 2012, it was first implemented in NRHM. That is National Health Rural Mission in Mumbai itself. And it was worked very fine. You know, Mr. Kharge is there, who is now the principal secretary to the chief minister. They were initiated this application. And it was worked, and still it is working very fine. These are so many district places already implemented, and other places also in the country. See, every place we are giving this application, posting this application either in the local data center or maybe in the cloud or maybe as per the desired places. See, here in India, we have implemented this application in 586 total locations, you can say. There are total 586 instances, and this many receipts were created. More than 2 crore files have been created. There are more than 7 lakhs users are there for e-office users. And I am proudly saying that out of this 7 lakh odd, we are having more than 60,000 users in Mumbai itself and Maharashtra. That's the biggest achievement for the Maharashtra state.
Garje sir.
Yeah.
Sir, please share your screen, sir. Only that screen is not sharing, sir. Please share the screen.
Okay. Actually, it's not showing. One second. I'm sharing once again.
Yes.
Are you waiting now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So I was talking about, now you are getting now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sorry, actually, I was thought that you were getting. No problem. Yes. So I'm proudly saying that we are having more than almost 1 lakh users in Mumbai itself. And in Maharashtra, that's the proud moment for us. Okay. Now, for this e-office application, there are two types of e-office available in NIC. One is called e-office Lite and one is called e-office Prime. I will tell you the difference between these two. Lite will consist of your movement of papers or movement of files in the organization. Okay. Whereas Prime will have all these things, file, then leave, tour, your personal management information system, and your Sparrow. All these things are available in Prime. Lite will have the file movement and the knowledge management. Now you ask me, what is knowledge management? It is basically a repository of our all documents, which we can keep at one place. And whenever it is required, that can be attached to the file or it can be taken out by the officer to read and to use for the future purpose or for his knowledge purpose. So that is the knowledge management. This application is thoroughly tested. As I said, it is working since last 10 years in Mumbai itself, and before that in other places in India. There are so many stages already gone through it. There are so many change, you can say, requests has been done, and now it is stable product. Now, for this application, we are doing authentication by using the Parichay. As you are knowing that, there is Jan Parichay and Parichay. There are two authentication available in central government. So we are authenticating you through this Parichay. Means any user who wants to access this application should have the email address. That is a government email address. Or if it is email address created in your own player, own organization, if you have your own, you can say LDAP, so you can, we can use that LDAP also. But it is authenticating through your Parichay. And all the security features have been taken care here. The file movement is with respect to the encrypted format. It is moving from one place to another place in an encrypted format. We are using here digital signature certificate to sign the application, to sign the file, or to sign the paper. Because in as per IT Act 2000, it is mandatory. If you want to present this to the court also, then also you can give sign through digitally and submit to them. So this is the thing. Now, as you know, everywhere, if you come to Mantralaya, because I'm sitting in Mantralaya, if you go to Mantralaya, from all our data bank or from the place where we keep all these files. It's very difficult. Now, using this application, if you use this application and you are 100% or you may be 50% of this EOFS, it is very easy. Within a fraction of a second, you can get the file where it is located or where it is placed or where it is pending. All these things can be get in a click of button only. Now, as I earlier said, this is a mission mode project of Government of India. Government of India wants that this should be used extensively in all the organization of the state government, central government, their local bodies, or the other departments. That's why this project has been emphasized by the government. You know, there are so many other projects also like e-office in the government, like e-procurement. You may be using for your purchase and your tendering process. Then there is the e-hospital for all the hospitals that is given by the central government. So this e-office is one of the part of it. It is designed by NIC. And it is only for the central and state government and their departments. We are not giving this to private organizations. So that's a thing. So it can be catered to the, all the possible things, all the things what are required by the state government departments or their allied agencies or the universities or corporations. Everywhere the same product is there. And it's a standard product. We don't have to customize anything for this. You have to just take this project, deploy at your place and use it. And it's a web-based application. As I said, you can host anywhere. It's on the cloud also. You can use your local data center to host this application, or you may go to the national cloud, which is given by NIC or the government, that is Meghraj. As I said, it's a standard file system across all the government organization. No need to change, no need to have any modifications. It is already implemented and working in all the departments. The file created in PDF format. When I was listening to Vice Chancellor, they were telling that people are taking printouts as and when it is, whenever they require. So whenever you use this application, you don't have to take any printout. We are having restrictions in this application. Sir said it is hierarchy based. Yes, it's a hierarchical based application. The file movement is from one place to another place. It's purely, nobody can jump from here and there. If I wanted to send one file to one person, I can send directly there. If I send a file to X person, the Y person cannot see the file until unless the file goes to him. So all this secrecy is maintained well in advance there. Secondly, sir asked about the printings. So I proudly say that we are given this application role-based. As per the role only, the people can access the application. If you are not having role of printing, you cannot get the print. If you don't have role of reports, you will not get the report. If you don't have, rights to close the file, you can't close the file. So all these things have already been taken care in this application. So I can assure that nothing to worry about using this application. Now, what are the objectives? I already told you. We want the system will help us to automate the movement of files. Now, what happened? We take the example. suppose one paper I received from Vice Chancellor office. I'm sitting at 100 kilometers away from the university. What I'm doing, when it receives to me, I'm taking Xerox of it. Isn't it? I'm taking the Xerox and submitting that paper to my subordinates. They are also taking the Xerox. It's a human tendency. We want to stop all these things. I will give one example, a live example. Suppose I want to visit, normally I give everywhere this example. Suppose I want to visit Delhi for some meeting. I'm booking my ticket. I'm getting web ticket on my mobile also. Or if I'm taking a booking rail ticket, it's coming on mobile also. But still, for safer side, I'm taking printouts. It is not required. So we want to stop all these things. So normally also, we should not take the printout. We should not carry the printout. Here also in the office, we should not have to take any printout. Now it enhances transparency. How it enhances transparency? Suppose now a file comes to me and I am not in the office. My VC, immediately he can check on his computer. He can track the file, where the file is located. It is with Garje. But Garje is not there in the office today. Since how long the file is pending with him, all these things he can check there. And whatever comments written by me, if I send that my file to my superior, he can see whatever comments written by me. And when he transfer that file to my junior also, the junior can see both the notings. But the thing is that the file should go to him. Then accountability, I said, since how long the file is pending with me, what I'm doing on that file, why I have not attended the file, when I received the paper in my department, what I've done with that paper, all these things can be tracked here in this application. Effectively, it will give the good MIS for the superiors. There are 100 number of reports available in these applications. For receipts also, when the paper comes to you, for files also, when the file comes to you, how much time has been taken by the persons to complete this file. Dual time report, you can take this from the application. You can know the file pendings in which section for how long, along with the days. Then how much time the one file is pending with the officer or the section. All these things can be tracked anytime. It will definitely reduce the processing delays. Now, sir said, your other departments are located more than 100 kilometers away from your university. Suppose one person or one department want to send one paper from their office to your office, either they will be choosing, they will be sending through email, or they may be using your speed post, or some one person is coming to you. But when you use this application, you don't have to send any person. You don't have to send any paper to anywhere. The paper will come to you instantaneously without any delay. A file, if a file compromise of 100 pages, 1000 pages, any number of pages, that will come instantaneously to you. So geographically diversified place also, you feel that you are working at one place only. As sir rightly pointed out that you are a very small place at Dapoli, but you are having good connectivity. And that is the backbone of this application. If you have a good connectivity, you will not feel any difference of physical things. And this application, whatever you are doing physically, all the things can be done possible. All the things are possible to do electronically. There is no difference at all. As I already told you, there is a you can assure data security and data integrity while transmitting this file. So what are the main features of this file? Now, what is the procedure manually what we are following? Whenever any paper comes to us, what we are doing, we are making entry into the ledger that we are calling inward entry, isn't it? Sometimes it is called tapal, somewhere it is called the receipts. So what we are doing, we are making entry of that particular paper in the ledger. We are mentioning that who has sent this letter, what is the date of that letter, what is the subject of that letter, and for whom it is meant to. And we are transmitting, or we are transferring that paper to another section, isn't it? This is a manual procedure. So here, we are calling that as a receipts. So for that purpose, we are having one model, that scanning model. Whenever any paper comes to you, we are telling that you should have one central registry unit wherein all your paper will come there only. There the paper will scan. And after scanning, only the document will move, not the paper. The paper will be kept at their own place only. Suppose today there is 100 papers. That 100 paper bunch they have to keep into their storage area. if department want to see that physical paper, then only the paper should go. Otherwise, it should not go, should not move from one place to another place. So that is called scanning model. Once the paper is scanned, we are making entries in physical diary register. Similar way, we are making those entry into the electronic format. See who is the sender of that letter, what is the letter date, when we received that letter in our department, when we are making diary of that, what is the subject of that, who is the sender of that particular paper. So all these things are getting recorded in the application. And another beauty of this application is that if a letter comes to me from Mr. Dr. Kohle, I am putting all these details into this application, metadata. One message is going into their email or their SM on their mobile that your letter is received in this organization. And this is the acknowledgement number. For future correspondence, you may refer this number and make a correspondence with us. So this is the beauty of this application. Second, if you create after getting the paper, what you are doing, either we are putting that paper into some file, isn't it? Or we are just taking some cognizance of the paper and sending to some other person, isn't it? These are two ways we are doing. Or we are just keeping that paper into our file. Now today's example. Today we have kept this brainstorming example, this session. They sent one letter to you. Now after this brainstorming session, we don't require that letter. No? We are just closing that. So in system also, we can close that letter which you received here electronically. So once you close the letter, it will go to the archival area. If you require again that letter, you can again retrieve that letter and send back to someone else. That is possible. Now, after receiving this letter, suppose I wanted to keep that letter into some file. How I can keep? The condition is that that file should be with me. If file is not with me, I cannot keep the letter into the file. Then if a file is suppose with some X person, then I need to send that letter to the X person and then he will send that letter. Now, take an example. One file is already created electronically and that is with VC. And I received one urgent paper from outside. Now I wanted to send that paper to VC in the same file. Here in this application, we are having one concept that is called a part file. We can create a part file of that original file and send that letter to VC in the part file. So VC will know that yes, there is a part file created for this and we have to see the action, we have to take the action using this letter also and another file also. So that is also available there. You can attach there. XML documents, you can attach .doc files, you can attach PDF there. Secondly, you can send any DO letter. See, normally what happened, we are sending letters from here to outside. Suppose VC wanted to send one DO letter to outside. How they are sending? They are sending physically, isn't it? But here, through file, you can directly send the letter. The condition is that the person's email address you must have. If an email address is available there, automatically you can dispatch that letter to that particular person or to a DO letter. So that is also possible here. Okay. As I said, the file can be authenticated using the digital signature certificate. So for that purpose, department need to procure digital signature dongles from the market. Now the cost is very less. This hardly you will be getting 600 rupees. And 600 rupees you can use for 2 years. There is another facility also available in the application that is e-signature. You can use this e-signature also in this application. But for that purpose, you need to have to coordinate with the CDAC because CDAC is the e-sign signature provider here. Application is ready with the e-sign. You have to go to the CDAC. CDAC will facilitate you to use this application, but there are charges that those are very costly. This costing is 3 rupees or 2 rupees per signature. If you compare with the digital signature certificate, this is too costly. But if you wanted to go, you can go. That is authenticated with the help of the UIDAI. You know, or Aadhaar number. You have to put Aadhaar number. Through Aadhaar, it will be authenticated through eSign. Now, as I said, the file can be processed from anywhere. Suppose sir is on tour to Mumbai, they can process this file from their laptop from Mumbai also. There won't be any restrictions for that because it's a web-based application. If I am using mobile, I can use through mobile also. Now, what are available in this application, this system? As I said, it is very user-friendly. Any person who is having 2 hours of training can use this application. It is just like your email only. We have conceptualized this email into this e-office, nothing else. So that was easy decision, which will help you to create the paperless, as I told you. Every person will get SMS alert or email alert. Suppose I create a file, and that file is forwarded to Kole sir. Kole sir, I suppose there is one, you can say checkbox is given that whenever Kole sir sends this file to their superior, one SMS or an email alert should get to me. So automatically when they transfer that file to their superior or some VC, I will get one alert on my mobile or an email stating that my file is reached to X person. So this is also available there. You can work from anywhere, fast processing is there. It's a Unicode compliant. You can use your local language also. You can do it in Marathi, Hindi, English, any of the local language available in India. Then you can close the file once its work is over. You can retrieve the file. You can put up a file again. You can reinitiate the file. Suppose one person is not available today. Suppose a file comes to me and I'm not available in the office. My superior is having authority to pull that file from me and allocate to someone else. But whenever such type of things are happening, that time system is recording one note there, why it has been taken from Mr. Garje and transferred to Mr. Kole. So one record should be available. Record we are capturing that, yes, Mr. Garje is on leave. That's why that file is the urgent file that is taken and transferred to Mr. Kole. So that facility is also available here. Every record is audit trail maintained. Every recorded time with the timestamp and desk stamps, everything is available there. You can track the file, you can track the receipt anytime from anywhere. You can pull back a file. Suppose I wanted to send a file to Mr. Kole and by mistake I forwarded that file to VC. I realized that no, it's wrongly I sent to VC. I should not have sent to VC, only to Mr. Kole I want to send. So I can pull that file till the VC sees that. When they open that file, then I cannot pull back that file. But till they open the file, I can pull that file and transfer to Mr. Kole. So that is also possible here. I can park my file. Suppose I don't want to process this file because I wanted to get some data from 2-3 departments and then I want to process this file and forward to some other person. So that is also possible here. So that is called parking of the file. Then, sir, ask me, suppose your person don't want to write comment there. He wanted to just give information or he want to take some guidance from the senior. So in this application, we are having concept of the green note and yellow note. So yellow note means what? Suppose I am not confident what I have to write into the file. So what I am writing, I am just preparing a yellow note and sending to my superior. Suppose Mr. Kole is my superior. I am sending to Kole. See, this is the thing I am writing this way, whether this is acceptable or not. If Kole sir want that, yes, it is a correct one or it is not correct, then they can modify that. So when I forwarded that yellow note to them, it becomes 1.0. When they modify it and send back to me, it becomes 1.1. So all the versions have been kept there. And if they satisfy, after I'm making correction, I can send back to them and they feel that yes, the file is now correct one. So they can make that file in a green note, that paper into a green note. Once it make a green note, now nobody can change that. So when I send a yellow note, Kole sir had modified something. They forward it to their superior, they have modified something, and lastly it goes to, suppose VC. VC sees that, yes, this is the proper note sheet is created, so they can also make this green note and make a confirm it. So that's also possible there. So nothing to worry about that. Then you can create in Word in your desktop and copy into this application also. That is also possible there. As I said, you can find, it's a live file image, you can track anytime, there is no problem at all. What are the additional benefits here? Suppose one person transfer from one place to another place. So this can be also achieved in this application. You can do a transfer posting in this application. So there is very easy in the admin menu. Then you can give additional charge. Sometimes it's possible that one person is working in X department. Y department person is on leave for 1 week. So that charge also can be given to the X person. So he will have two charges, A and B, two charges. If third person also gone on leave, so you can give third charge also. So that charge giving facility also available here. You can give the delegation also. If I am on leave, I can give delegate my power to my subordinate as per the rule and he can process my files. MIS reports also. Authority wise, I already told, with the authority only it can be given to them. The file printing option cannot be given to everyone because we want to stop the printing in the organization. that way we can save a lot of paper also, that way a lot of cost also. And secondly, we can achieve the go green concept. A lot of trees have been cut because of this paper. That also possible. Then you should have government email IDs for authentication through the Pariche. Then DSC signing facility is given on both your noting also, as in draft also. You can dispatch. Now what happened, if I want to dispatch one paper, what I need to do? I have to go to the post, isn't it? I have to call my sepoy. He will go to court, post. He will send that letter. Here, whatever you can do directly self, dispatch it possible. But only thing is that the email address of the person should have with you. Or we can send that to central issue unit. They can also dispatch the things. So here we can minimize the manpower. Now after implementation, we want this. Your table should like this only. There are departments in Mumbai. I can name the department. Department of Atomic Energy. Very, very near to Mantralaya. There are 100% on the office. Bhabha Atomic Research Center. There are 100% on this e-office. There are not a single paper is moving. In there, all seven departments. Kokan Railway. There each station is one office. Now earlier, they used to take months to come file from Jammu or Karwar to Mumbai head office. Now it is coming instantaneously. So they got benefited out of it. So these all things can be achieved using this application. Now, as I said, there are so many reports are available. How many files have been created in your department? How many papers is received in your department? How many papers you have forwarded to X department, Y department, Z department? How many files you have received in your department? How much time you have taken to process it, that file in your department? All these things are available here. You can have daily register, how many papers received, how many of these things. Now I wanted to show you one small demo if it is permitted to me. Otherwise, this is my presentation. I can take your questions if any questions are available from there. Police sir, can you?
Sir, Honorable VC sir, can we take the demonstration, sir?
No problem. I mean,
if I will give 10 minutes, I will show you how it will look like only if it is permitted.
Okay, sir. You can proceed, sir. Yes.
Sir, are you able to see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, what I'm saying, I am having one demo user created for giving a presentation to all the departments. So this is a user. As I said, this is authenticated with respect to the Pariche. So what you need to have, you need to give your email address here. Where now, suppose I'm having that eoffice.fmc, their own email address. Likewise, prakash.kole, their email address, they can put it here and they can log into this. So I'm using one demo user for me. This thing is there. Whenever first time you use this application, one OTP will come on your mobile. So that's because we want that other people should not use this application. Suppose you are not at your place and it is open, so you should not use this application. So we are using this authentication through OTP also. But when you are next time you are using the application, don't ask me again. Also, you can do it, and next time it will not ask you on that particular PC. That's also given there. Now, see, this is my application. Now, on the left hand side, you are finding e-office services, that file management system. Their MIS reports are there for our senior management. That non-end management is nothing but your all repository of your library data or your important data. One second. sorry. So on left hand side, you are all getting this menu: file management, MIS reports, knowledge management, PIMS, that is person management, leave management, and tour management. But as I said, there are two types of UOPs available in NIC. So one is light. Light will have only file and the KMS. So I will not take much time. I will directly go to the file management, how it looks like. So I'm just clicking there. Now, what happened actually, earlier we are having another version of the UOPs. Now we have gone with new version, that is 7.0 version. Those, the sites which are coming right now on this UOPs application, we are giving them the 7.2.0 version. Now in Mumbai, there is only one site who is using this application, using this 7.2.0 version. That is the Cotton Corporation of India in Mumbai. So here you find receipts, file, dispatch, then your received letters, notifications. See, what happened actually, the receipts is nothing but the letters which you are receiving in your organization. Means the letters, the papers which are coming to you. Now here what happened, whenever letter comes to you, what you have to do? You have to scan the letter, as I already told you. How to scan the things? See here, browse and arrange option is given there, isn't it? You have to just go there and scan the things. Suppose you already scanned their letter, you can just upload the things. See here, upload option is given there. You can see. Now just scan. There is one letter is already scanned there. I'm just opening that letter. It is very simple only. And on the right hand side, you will be finding the diary details. Diary details in the sense that whatever we are receiving in a paper format, those details we want to add it here. Like suppose diary details, when, what is the date of that diary, means when you are doing, then what is it, how the delivery mode, how I received through email, or to paper, or to dispatch, whatever it may be, that all things are given here. I can say email I received, then when I received, then who has sent that letter to me, I given name here, Lakshmikant Garje. Here the details means the sender details, who is sent the letter to you, that details we need to add here. Then importantly, you tell your officers to always give their mobile number. That is more important. If you give the mobile number, this is what happened, the person will receive the SMS alert on his mobile stating that. Are you getting, sir, this? So all this, this, see, wherever there is a star mark, that is only mandatory. Rest of the fields are not mandatory. Okay. Now I'm just putting one subject there. Now see, here are, there are three options are there. Generate, generate, send, and generate copy. What does it mean? Generate means what? I have taken the paper, written everything on the diary and not given any number. That is generate. Generate send means what? I written everything, I generated a number also and sending that copy to another person. I'm just doing the generate send. So only this many entries you need to do. Once it has been done, you don't have to send this paper to the next receiving person. You are just sending the electronic format to them. So here you will get the number. See, this is number 1406/2021/finance section. See, what does it mean? File, that is the number, receipt number, then year and the department. Suppose you are having HR department, your fishery department, your computer department, or VC section. All these names will automatically appear there in the paper. Now suppose I want to send this letter to three persons. How I can send? Just add you two there. If I know the name, I can directly put their name and it can send. And earlier I told you, notify through email and SMS. Suppose I want to know that when the person has seen this paper and forwarded it to another person, I should get one SMS or email. If I tick mark this, I will get one SMS and one email there. Now this is the off the record remark available. I'm just sending that to, and see, I can give the priority also. Suppose I want to see that this letter should be on priority to attend by my subordinate. So I can give that priority also. And I'm just sending that letter. See, now that letter is gone to the person. See, this is the way.
I'm just opening another window. So whenever I'm doing, suppose I'm using my this thing now. I'm just logging to my my login now, because the letter is forwarded to me. I am logging into my application. Whenever you receive any letter, that will come to your inbox only, like your email. Now see, my inbox is open and that letter come to me. See, this is a letter come to me. That is 1406-2021 finance section, and from who has forwarded that letter to me, Suresh Sura, and when it has been forwarded. All these things will appear here. Now I want to see this letter. I'm just opening that letter. So this way you will get the letter. And if you want to put this letter into file, how you will do? You are just having that put in a file option. You just click there. One file is pending with me. I'm just opening that file. Just open that file. And directly inside, it will go to that particular file. So this way, this e-file and receipts and other things can be work in this application. So this is very small. I wanted to show you one receipt presentation and demonstration. Then leave is also there. Whenever you go for this application, we are ready to give you complete hands-on training to you, complete employee master training to you. For this application, you need to collect your data from all the departments. We call that as the employee master data. That data need to be updated in the application when you want to go this go live for that application. This is the thing I want to tell. If any questions are there, I am ready to take questions, or you can go to another speaker as per the. Thank you very much for listening to my
patient. Thank you, Garja sir, for explaining the details about the MS Office and live demonstration, sir. Sir, any questions to the Garja sir from our side, sir, university? All participants? Okay, yes, sir. Thank you,
sir. Yes, sir. By for operating this e-file system, you should mostly need NIC or government login, email ID login.
You can have NIC email ID also, you can have government email ID also, you can have your own email IDs also. If you have your own LDAP, that also is possible.
We can operate.
Authentication will not be there.
Yes, we can operate with our own email also.
Own email not. You have to have government email address only. You cannot use Gmail, you cannot use Rediff Mail, you cannot use Yahoo. But government email ID, you can use that. But if you have your Kokon Shiddhapit email IDs, your own LDAP, that is possible. You can integrate that. There is no problem.
Sir, Honorable Vishy, sir, can we proceed next speaker?
Progress.
So thank you, sir, Garja sir, explaining the details about the MS Office, sir. So next speaker is the Sandeep Patil, sir. He is a auditor, district audit officer, sir, and he will explain the because of number of time the query will be arise regarding the e-office and the audit point of view. So Mr. Sandeep Patil will explain the details, sir. Sandeep Patil, sir, please.
Namaskar, sir. Hello.
Hello, sir. Sandeep Patil, please, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Namaskar, sir. Me Sandeep Patil. Me Marathi bolle tari chalel na?
Chalel, sir.
Yes. Okay. Me Sandeep Patil, Jilla Leka Pariksha Adhikari, Kokon Krushi Vidyapeeth Dapoli. Sadyasthitit majhyakade ha atirikt karyabhar ahe Dapoli Krushi Vidyapeethacha. Mi gelya varshi apan gelya ek 2-4 mahinyapurvi apan magil 3 varshacha leka parikshan purna kele ani atta apla 19-20 या आर्थिक वर्षाचं लेखापरीक्षण सुरू आहे. तर लेखापरीक्षण करत असताना आम्हाला काही गोष्टी म्हणजे सर्वसाधारण ज्या त्रुटी आढळल्या त्याबाबत मला तुमच्या सर्वांशी चर्चा करायला आवडेल. सगळ्यात महत्वाचा एक विषय त्यातला होता म्हणजे आपल्याकडं कुठलाही शासकीय निधी वापरत असताना आपण वित्तीय औचित्याचे काही सूत्रांचं पालन केलं पाहिजे. त्यामध्ये ही शासनाचा जो निधी आहे तो जसा आपला घरचा निधी आहे किंवा आपल्या खिशातली जशी रक्कम आहे त्या पद्धतीने वापरण्याबाबत आपण काळजी घेतली पाहिजे. त्या अनुषंगानं आपण एखादी वस्तू घेत असताना एखादी सेवा विकत घेत असताना किंवा तिचा लाभ घेत असताना जास्तीत जास्त कमी किमतीला आणि चांगल्या दर्जाची ती कशी मिळेल यासाठी तुम्ही सर्वांनी सर्व एचओडी असतील तुम्ही सर्वांनी प्रयत्न करणं आवश्यक आहे. त्या अनुषंगाने शासनाचा दिनांक 1/12/2016 उद्योग ऊर्जा आणि कामगार विभागाचा एक शासन निर्णय आहे. ही शासकीय सेवेमध्ये शासनाच्या सर्व विभागांनी वस्तू आणि सेवा खरेदी करत असताना कोणत्या गोष्टींचे पालन केले पाहिजे याबाबत 1/12/2016 जवळजवळ तो 125 पानाचा जी आर आहे. त्यामध्ये अगदी क्लिअर दरपत्रक कारवाई कशी करावी ई टेंडरची प्रोसिजर कशी करावी याबाबत अगदी क्लिअर सूचना दिलेल्या आहेत उद्योग ऊर्जा आणि कामगार विभागात. आणि मला वाटतं की तुमच्या सर्व एचओडीनी किंवा जे खरेदी करणारे तुमच्यातील जे लोक आहेत त्या सर्वांनी सदरच्या जी आरचं अगदी काटेकोरपणे वाचन करून चांगल्या पद्धतीनं आणि कोणतीही त्रुटी न राहता तुमची सर्व खरेदी कशा पद्धतीनं पूर्ण होईल याबाबत काळजी घेतली पाहिजे. याबाबत तुम्हाला कधीही शंका असतील तर आमच्या विभागाशी कधीही त्याबाबत संपर्क करायला हरकत नाही. आणि जर हा जी आरचं तंतोतंत पालन केलं तर मला वाटतं की आपल्या लेखापरीक्षणात येणाऱ्या ज्या त्रुटी आहेत त्या बऱ्यापैकी कमी होतील आणि तुम्हालाही त्याबाबत फायदा होईल. त्याच्यानंतरचा आणखी एक विषय आहे तो म्हणजे आता शासनानं आता आपण ई ऑफिस बाबत मार्गदर्शन झालं ई ऑफिस बाबतच बोलतोय आणि त्या अनुषंगानं शासनानं महाराष्ट्र शासन किंवा केंद्र शासनानं त्यांच्याकडील कार्यालयानं आवश्यक असणाऱ्या सर्व वस्तूंची खरेदी एक पोर्टल केले जसं अमेझॉन पोर्टल आहे फ्लिपकार्ट पोर्टल आहे तसं शासनाचं एक जेम नावाचं पोर्टल आहे गव्हर्नमेंट ई मार्केट प्लेस नावाचं. शासनाचा 24/8/2017 वित्त विभागाचा शासन निर्णय त्यामध्ये त्याचे सर्व डिटेल्स दिलेले आहेत. तर सर्व वस्तू त्या जेम पोर्टलवर अवेलेबल आहेत अगदी संगणक पासून प्रिंटर पासून ते तुम्हाला शासकीय कार्यालयात लागणार उपलब्ध आहे. आणि कोणतीही दरपत्रक कारवाई कागदोपत्री न करता त्या पोर्टलवरच तुम्हाला बीड लावून पोर्टलवरच दरपत्रकाची कारवाई करून तुलना करून त्या पद्धतीने वर्क ऑर्डर देण्याबाबतची तरतूद उपलब्ध करून दिली आहे. तर मला वाटतं की हे जेम पोर्टल सर्व डिपार्टमेंट जेवढे जेवढे खरेदी करतात त्या सगळ्यांनी त्या जेम पोर्टलवर आपलं लॉग इन करावं. त्यासाठी जेम पोर्टलचा तुम्हाला लॉग इन आय डी पासवर्ड उपलब्ध होऊ शकतो आणि जेम पोर्टलवरून यापुढे जर खरेदी केली तर कोणत्याही त्रुटी राहणार नाही. त्या जेम पोर्टलवर अगदी एखाद्या वस्तूची तुलना कशी करायची त्याची स्पेसिफिकेशन कसे बघायचे तुम्हाला आवश्यक कुठले आहे हे सर्व डिटेल्स तिथे दिलेले आहेत. त्यामुळे यापुढे सर्व खरेदी करत असताना शासनाच्या या पोर्टलवरून करणे बंधनकारक शासनाने केले. एखादी वस्तू यावर नसेल उपलब्ध तरच तुम्ही ती बाजारभावानं दरपत्रकाच्या आधारे घेऊ शकता. त्यामुळे मला असं वाटतं की तुमच्या सर्व कोकण कृषी विद्यापीठातील सर्व एचओडी असतील सर्व खरेदी करणारे जे तुमचे अधिकारी कर्मचारी असतील त्यांनी या जेम पोर्टलवरून खरेदी करावी. आणखी एक विषय मला गेल्या वर्षी आढळला होता की तुम्ही कोणत्याच ठिकाणी बऱ्यापैकी मक्तेदाराला एखादी रक्कम दिली देयक अदा केलं तर त्यामधून आयकर कपात केली जात नाही. तर मला असं वाटतं की आपल्याला कंपल्शन आहे शासकीय विभागानं की कोणतीही रक्कम ज्यावेळी तुम्ही 30,000 वरती एखादी रक्कम एखाद्या पुरवठादाराला अदा करताय त्यावेळी त्याच्या देयकातून 2% रक्कम आयकर कपात करणे अपेक्षित आहे. त्याला बसतो न बसतो हा भाग वेगळा आहे. त्याला आयकर बसतो का नाही याचा आपण विचार करायची गरज नाही. ते त्याचं त्याने बघायचं आहे आपण त्याचं डिडक्शन करायचं आहे तुमच्या टॅननं त्याच्या पॅनला ती रक्कम भरायची आहे आणि त्याला त्याच्याबाबतची कागदपत्र आपल्या ऑफिसकडून पुरवायचे आहेत की जेणेकरून तो त्याचे जर त्याला बसत नसेल आयकर तो त्याचे रिटर्न घेऊ शकेल. पण आपली ही जबाबदारी आहे की 2% आयकर रक्कम आपण त्याच्या बिलातून वसूल करून आयकर खाती भरणं करणं आवश्यक आहे. याबाबत गेल्या वेळी चर्चा झाली आहे तुमच्यातल्या बऱ्याच लोकांचं असं मत होतं की एखादी वस्तू आपण बाजारात ज्यावेळी थेट विकत घेतो त्यावेळी आयकर वजा करायची गरज नाही. बरोबर आहे पण आपण वस्तू घेत असताना स्पेसिफिकेशननुसार घेतो आपल्या आवश्यकतेप्रमाणे घेतो आणि त्यामध्ये अशी तरतूद आहे ज्यावेळी तुम्ही तुमच्या स्पेसिफिकेशननुसार एखादी वस्तू बाजारातून खरेदी करता त्यावेळी आयकर कपात करणं हे खरेदी जो खरेदी करतो त्याची जबाबदारी आहे. त्याच्याबरोबरच आणखी एक विषय आला की GST ज्या एखाद्या खरेदीचं देयक 2.5 लाखाच्या वर आहे तर अशा खरेदीच्या ह्याच्यातून आयकर कपात तर 2% केली पाहिजेच परंतु GST अगेनेस्ट 2% TDS म्हणून GST TDS पण 2% कपात करणं आवश्यक आहे आणि तो GST खाती भरणा करणं अपेक्षित आहे. याच्या बरोबरच तुमच्याकडचे साठा रजिस्टर असतील त्यामध्ये ह्या सर्व वस्तूंच्या अगदी काटेकोरपणे नोंदी केल्या गेल्या पाहिजेत, आणि मागील साठा शिल्लक असेल तर पुढील साठा घेत असताना थोडासा विचार केला पाहिजे. आवश्यक आहे त्याच वस्तू घेणे आणि आवश्यक आहे तेवढीच घेऊन जास्तीत जास्त काटकसर करून विद्यापीठाला याबाबतचा फायदा उपलब्ध करून देण्याच्या दृष्टीने तुम्ही सर्वांनी प्रयत्न केले पाहिजे. धन्यवाद माझ्याकडून आजच्या या ह्याच्यासाठी.
जरा हे टाका
शेवट.
हा पाटील साहेब, तुम्ही बोललात ते बरोबर आहे सगळ्या गोष्टी, पण आजचा विषय असा होता की सपोज आपण ई ऑफिस हे केलं, इम्प्लिमेंट केलं,
यस सर,
तर ऑडिट पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू आम्हाला काय काय डिफिकल्टीज येणार आहेत, किंवा कुठल्या गोष्टीमध्ये आपण ई ऑफिस इम्प्लिमेंट करताना काळजी घेतली पाहिजे सो दॅट ज्या ऑडिटच्या रिक्वायरमेंट आहेत त्या आपण फुलफिल करू शकू.
सर बरोबर आहे. ई ऑफिस करत असताना मला असं वाटतं की तुम्ही ज्या सॉफ्टवेअर कुणाकडे तरी सॉफ्टवेअर घेणार असाल किंवा कुठल्या तरी कंपनीला देणार असाल तर त्यांच्याकडून त्यामध्ये एक ऑडिट ट्रेल घेणं गरजेचं. म्हणजे तुम्ही जी काय प्रोसिजर कराल ती प्रत्येक प्रोसिजर ऑडिट ट्रेलला पडली पाहिजे की जेणेकरून उद्या आम्ही त्या ठिकाणी ऑडिटला आलो किंवा इतर कोणी ऑडिटला आले तर त्यांना तुम्ही जी केलेली प्रोसिजर आहे ते ऑडिट ट्रेलला सर बघायला मिळाले पाहिजे की जेणेकरून तुम्हाला कुठलाही कागद आम्हाला दाखवावं लागणार.
मग त्याची ऑथेंटिसिटी वगैरे कशी आपण व्हेरीफाय करायची हा प्रश्न असतो. म्हणजे बऱ्याचशा वेळेला आपण परचेस प्रोसिजर केलेले कोटेशन्स किंवा असे काही जे असतात ते ई कॉपीज असतात.
बरोबर सर.
मग त्या सध्याच्या परिस्थितीमध्ये तुम्हाला कशा पद्धतीच्या हव्या असतात आणि त्या आम्हाला ई ऑफिस मधून मिळू शकतील का?
हो सर, तुम्ही आता मुद्दा तुमचा बरोबर आहे की त्या ऑथेंटिकेशनचा प्रश्न उद्भवणार आहे, परंतु मला असं वाटतं की तुम्ही सर्वजण जर ई ऑफिस वापरणार असाल आणि ते तुमच्या ऑफिसच्या त्याच्यामध्ये चांगल्या पद्धतीची जी सिक्युरिटी हे असेल प्रोसिजर असेल तर आम्ही ते स्वीकारायला आम्हालाही काही हरकत नाही सर. या जो ऑडिटरीला जे कागद पडतील ते आम्ही ऑथेंटिक म्हणून घ्यायला हरकत नाही.
ओके ओके यस थँक्यू.
यस सर थँक्यू.
यामध्ये कसं माहितीये की आपण जे डॉक्युमेंट करतोय ते डेटले सिग्नेचर करतोय आणि जेव्हा डेटले सिग्नेचर करून आपण आपल्याला पाठवू, जसं आपण म्हणलं की जर सगळे जर ई ऑफिस युज करत असतील तर मला तुम्हाला काही प्रॉब्लेम यायला नाही पाहिजे. आणि खरी गोष्ट आहे, आता आपण कोकण रेल्वेमध्ये बघतोय आपण की त्यांच्याकडे पण आम्ही जे पूर्ण ऑडिट जे आहे ते पूर्ण टोटली आम्ही ई ऑफिस मध्येच करतो. त्यांचे जे मॅन्युअल त्यांचे जे बिल्स प्रोसेसिंग वगैरे आहे ते सर्व आपण ई ऑफिस मार्फत पाठवतो. तसं आपल्याला माहिती आहे की काही काही वेळेस आपल्याला बिल जे आहे ते ओरिजिनल मध्ये पाहिजे असतात, मग त्या केसमध्ये जेव्हा तुमची फाईल लास्टला प्रोसेस होईल त्यावेळेस तुम्ही ते फाईल ओरिजिनल बिल त्याच्याकडे ऍक्सेप्ट करू शकता करता येईल त्यामध्ये. आणि सेकंडली कसं माहिती याच्यामध्ये सर की जर समजा आपल्याला सरांनी जसं विसाहेबांनी बोलले की एखादा युजर आयडी तुम्हाला क्रिएट करून दिला ऑडिट सेक्शनला त्यावर तुम्हाला मॉनिटर करता येईल त्यावर देईल
तर आम्हाला त्याची युजर आयडी पासवर्ड असणं गरजेचं आहे.
बस त्यामध्ये मिळेल काय प्रॉब्लेम त्यामध्ये.
यस यस यस
थँक्यू. थँक्यू पाटील सर. सर पाटील सरांनी आता आपल्याला सर ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द हाऊ द ई ऑफिस अँड ऑडिट पॉईंट ऑफ व्ह्यू अँड ऑलरेडी दे आर कमिटेड टू ऍक्सेप्ट ऑल दीज व्हेन दे हॅव द युजर पासवर्ड अँड लॉग इन आय डी. थँक्यू पाटील सर. सर मी स्पीकर आहे डॉक्टर आर सी गोयल सर. ही इज इमिनंट सायंटिस्ट रिटायर्ड प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम इंडियन स्टॅटिस्टिकल ऍग्रिकल्चर इन्स्टिट्यूट सर अँड ऑल द इनिशिएटिव्ह राईट फ्रॉम द इस्टॅब्लिशमेंट सर इन द आय सी टी ही इज हॅव्हिंग द सर मेजर लिडिंग रोल. सर आर सी गोयल सर प्लीज प्रेझेंट.
थँक्यू डॉक्टर कोले फॉर कन्सिडरिंग मी टू हॅव सम डिस्कशन ड्युरिंग दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्रोग्राम. So at my own behalf, definitely I would like to welcome all the participants who are present in this particular meeting and others also who could not join because of one reason or the other. They are not able to join, but still it's a great opportunity to discuss the issues with regard to e-resources, rather we call it e-office, e-learning. Particularly, they have asked me to give some discussion on e-learning. E-learning, definitely there is a lot to discuss. And since I am being involved in this particular issue since, say, 2010, if we recall in 2010, there was a project for National Agriculture Innovation Project, where we initiated this activity, e-learning, if I say a platform where the learning concepts are being provided to the learners. Very simple definition, learning concepts are provided to the learners. Learners may be anybody, school learners, college learners, and scientists, and even vice chancellor, or anybody. All are learners at one point or the other. So e-learning means the concepts are provided through e-resources. So at that stage in 2010 or so, we get planned that at least because we belong to National Agriculture Research System, we should have a great platform which should be accessible to the agriculturalist in the country, not only in the country, in the world as a whole. We made the access to the entire global community related to agriculture sciences in 2010. So at that time, it was planned that because we being in education and research, so initially it was initiated for UG programs that are being taught in agriculture education system. And you know that we have got a very big setup for agriculture education consisting of, say, about 74 agricultural universities in the country, including all veterinary, animal science, and fisheries, dairy, and forestry, horticulture, and everything. That makes our agriculture. One word, agriculture, includes everything. That I did not repeat. So for that, we planned at that stage that we should try and we should make a platform wherein we could provide the learning material to all our students, and to start with for the UG level students. So that platform was initiated at that stage, and it was made accessible. And in that, in fact, the content that were created were on all the disciplines, veterinary science, dairy, forestry, then your agriculture, fisheries, and veterinary and animal sciences. So all these contents, and what contents were there, that is more important. Because the contents were exactly the lecture notes with regard to the UG program which are being taken up in the country, in different colleges, different universities, because they say 500 and odd colleges are there, which are constituent to all these universities. And there are many other colleges which are affiliated to this. In addition to this, there are students, because our objective is to create human resources in agriculture research for its developmental activities. So at that time, we initiated this activity and made this portal accessible. And at that time, it was really a popular portal. And it was a great aid for classroom teaching. People say when the entire material is provided on the platform, what is the necessity of classroom, or it will become a classroom substitute. But here I don't agree. It can never be a substitute for the classroom teaching. And I think we all should agree that classroom teaching is classroom teaching. Then we provide various aids, like libraries are there. Then this kind of portal, lot of portals are existing, but not related to exact material which are being taught in UG level in the state agriculture university. And that particular portal, I think some of you must be aware of that. Somehow we could not popularize to that extent in our country as it became popular in the world. If we see the utility and access to that portal, it was more in abroad, like Australia, US, and other countries. The students from the agriculture universities abroad, they were giving access and downloading the material. Whereas in our country also, it was tremendously utilized by the students. Now, but as the time passes, e-learning will have to become a substitute. And because of this corona, if you find nowadays corona platform, in this corona, it has become really a requirement, not as an aid, but requirement of the time. And I remember when during 2010 or so, We used to talk about this kind of platform. They used to laugh and they used to say, no, 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 how it is possible, how we can do all these things. Because there was a lot of constraints, like web, internet connectivity. It was very poor, very, very poor. So in that environment, it was really difficult just to cope up with this kind of portal. But somehow we were bent upon that. This is a great requirement and we have to go for it. And at that time, as per Dean Force, the committee recommendations, entire portal is still surviving. It is available. But now, Dean's fifth committee, Dean's recommendations, they revised the entire, means not exactly entire, but they made changes to the existing curriculum. And because of that, now again, we need revision. And here I am coming to the point that needs a revision as per fifth Dean's committee recommendation. And we planned and under this, now you must be aware of Nesha Agriculture Higher Education Project. Under agriculture, higher education means exactly all of you are well learned and maybe knowing better than me. Higher education, what is the necessity? Necessity definitely is there because our agriculture discipline, I always say why people feel it as the tail end discipline. Why it is not coming to the forefront? If you just see agriculture education, you see in your own house itself, you being a father or a parent, what priority or what options you feel like to give to your children. Everybody feels, no, 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 my son or daughter must be a doctor. If not doctor, then engineer or chartered accountant. If nowhere, no admission is possible, but they appear for some competitive examinations and they get possibly that agriculture education. Why at the last? Why at the tail end? It's a really a big question to be thought of. You all learned agriculture experts and stalwart in the field of for the agriculture research and development. Why agriculture is the tail end? Because we are not giving emphasis on higher education. Even in agriculture graduate, there's those who pass out UG. Have we ever thought of what percentage of our students are coming to PG? Is there any possibility? So we find that very few people after doing UG, they are getting involved in small jobs because there is a feeling because they belong to farming community or either they are from the remote villages. Why that concept? We have to do a lot of work in this line. That's why again it was thought of that we should come out again with the latest e-learning concepts for UG. First thing is we have to revise as per the Dean's Committee recommendations. First revision is going on. Incidentally, I am involved in this particular project also. Just the concerned officials just approached and they asked because I am basically involved since beginning. So in this particular project, if you see, we have to create the contents of the higher category. Means higher category in the sense that the time and technology has changed. And for that, again, we have invited people to create the contents or revise the contents. There are two stages because there are few courses which needs a revision. There are few courses which needs to be created as a new course, entirely changed. So that we have invited. And in that also, I'm not blaming any particular university, but we are finding not that good response which it should have been. So that is the, in fact, purpose to create another new portal for UG, and not only UG, we have to think for PG and research. PG programs, we have to see why students are not moving towards PG or PhD. Unless we give a proper thought for PG courses, we can never survive or we can never be compared with the world development. And that is not difficult. And the contents we have to provide because our now environment has changed. We have to depend on this kind of things, not only this e-learning contents, along with this, we'll have to strengthen with, because in e-learning, there was always a discussion, how to provide the practicals. And it was true. It is true also. Practicals can be conducted in the labs. But now technology is changing faster. We are coming out with the alternate virtual reality. We are going to create the practicals like virtual reality is a concept wherein we can create the exact environment, not as a video, exact environment how a particular experiment is conducted, like some operation for a particular dog or a cow or any, even for artificial insemination you take. If you talk about how exactly it is being done, that can be put in the virtual reality format. So along with the learning, we have to add all these practical aspects and which can be very well taken up. And we are taking up this project. It is successfully being operational and becoming operational slowly because it takes time and our definitely university people are cooperating for providing the material. But still in virtual concept, if you talk about the virtual reality, we are at the very beginning stage. But I assure that really we are getting excellent results. We are getting really, it looks like as we are sitting in the farm. It's not a video. You will see exactly to the deepest location of a particular body, cut body, deepest location will be made visible to the students or to the learners so that they will not realize that practically they are in the farm or they are in the lab or they are just seeing virtually. So that concept has come. We have to strengthen because we don't know. Corona 19 after this Delta, Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta, and now again this Omicron. Recently it has come up. We don't know what will be the next or what will be the current state of art for particular this. So here I would like definitely request to all the learned faculty members and the management in particular, dean, directors, and it becomes a responsibility to take care for this kind of activities. And in fact, you should come forward for because this e-learning we are advertising and generally we are inviting the people who can just create these contents and all those things. So this is such a platform where we can discuss these issues and I open it for all the faculty members to discuss if they want to discuss about this, how we can go on, what is the requirement and how far they are participating, because people are participating but not to the extent it is required and not with a zeal. With that, they should just cooperate and try to provide the material well in time. There are many issues so that it is not the platform. But here we can discuss how we can improve upon or what are the confusions in this field, why we are not able to go ahead. Because government is providing funding, everything. And we have got a lot of, you can say, stamina and that intelligence among our agricultural scientists. We can definitely come out along with our technological developments. And for technological developments, we are again at the top of the country. You must have seen our people. They are in the top, I think, IT world. They are in the CEOs in most of the, if you name many of them. Indians. So we can go for that. So here I'll invite if I don't know the session is for discussion also or just Dr. Kohle. We can have a one-to-one discussion also if somebody are interested in just having some few clarifications or so forth.
All the faculty members, sir, can you have any issues to can explain to Dr. Goel, sir, please?
Issue, not only issue, some suggestions for if they feel that something can be done in another different way, because we have, all of you must be aware how we are just getting the contents created. Although the process has become slightly stressed, in the sense we are going for a more accuracy. Like one course is allocated to some, one course is divided in some module, 4 or 5 modules. Even we have given the option, one faculty member can opt for a single module only. Not the entire course. If 4 modules are there, 4 faculty members can take independent and they can create the content. Because now we are very keen to create the quality content. Quality is more important. Quality content, once our faculty members create and who none other can create that quality, which a teacher who is exactly teaching that particular course. he must be having an experience of 4, 5, 6 years, and in 6 years, 10 years, he get lot of opportunities to improve upon that particular course content. So if anybody has got any suggestion,
sir, more sir, please.
And one more thing I will request here. Please give us some suggestions from practical point of view, how we can go for this virtual reality concept. How we can have one practicals you can just what you conduct in your lab. You please send us some detail. You can contact me and you can send me so that we can convert into virtual reality experiment. You are creating in the lab, you are doing in the farm, you are doing so that some detail you give, we can just send our team or we can just create that in our technical labs, and then we'll give it to you for evaluation. We will just seek feedback from you all. That will be very important. Along with this, another very important issue, which in e-learning, I would like to request all of you, as we have created virtual classrooms in some of the universities under the project. Some 18 classrooms, 18 universities are provided virtual classrooms. And then along with the virtual classroom, in virtual classroom, you can take up the classes which can be webcasted and everything. I'm not, I'll not tell detail. So that can be done. And along with that, once you take the classes, once these are webcasted, then videos with regard to each and every class can be created. These videos, we are going to have a library of videos along with e-learning. Videos in the form, like suppose you have taken one class on a particular topic. So that will be one video. Another video, second class, third class. The large number of videos will be there, would be classified as per the disciplines and so forth. And once these are classified, we can think of something parallel to, just thinking, we can have something parallel to like YouTube. We are depending upon YouTube. We are putting everything. Why on YouTube? Why don't we have our own platform where agriculture, everything related to agriculture can be put on YouTube, and you just ask anything like YouTube, you will get 10 options. Same lecture video created by Dapoli, created by US Darwad, created by some other North University. And that would be made accessible. So that is one additional thing which we can go for e-learning. So videos can be very easily created with the Krishi Diksha portal, which we have, or the software which we have purchased in NIHCP component. I think Dapoli, I don't know exactly whether it is included in virtual classroom or not. I would like to know from the Dr. P.B. Kole, P.R. Kole. Your university is included in this?
Yes, sir. Already, sir, we have started the Nahape project, sir. Sir, yeah. Dr. Mohor and Dr. Borke, sir, will be looking after that. So I request, sir, Mohor, sir, joining this meeting, sir, please, sir.
Hello.
So in that way, just what my only concept was, if we are going to able to have large number of videos, people, not only the classroom videos, some seminar videos, some other training program to the farming community, extension videos, everything related to agriculture, some experiments you are conducting, you can have video also. Virtual reality platform is different and video platform is entirely different. There is no relation among the two. Virtual reality is exactly like as you conduct the experiment in your lab. So, but this video concept, if we are going to have large number of videos, like even suppose you are having some cultural program, the video with but it should be related to agricultural activities, because we want to restrict for agricultural research and development activities on that particular platform, where you will just upload all the videos provided by different state agriculture universities. And finally, we may come out with some naming, as I have told you, tube, something. Wherein everything related, nothing else. So this is my small ideas which I wanted to share with you all. And now that platform, please, you can discuss. You can just.
Sir, my yes. Query is there. Hello.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, sir, I'm Dr. Mohor. I'm working as head agriculture engineering here, and also one of the co-PI for NIHCP project for in which a virtual reality and module development is the one of the component.
All right, then you are no better than me.
Yeah, sir, our my question is, during these last 2 years, many of the course teacher has conducted the courses of their own courses by using a online mode. And during that period, we develop our own structure of the course conduction. Maybe yes. The video, maybe the online quiz, maybe the assignments, maybe the videos, or maybe
yes, yes, yes.
So that compile information is with us now.
Yes. Now,
is there any platform is available to make the authentication of that course so that it is applicable to all?
Definitely.
For that purpose, what you are saying that your NAHEP is working on that one, and 18 universities has already joined in that one.
So yeah.
I don't think our university is connected to NAHEP, ICAR NAHEP for the writing and content creator as a book, but not as a virtual module which is developed by our teacher, and we are not get the authenticated source from some of the source. And if your NAHEP is there and 18 universities already included in that one,
yeah,
we also, if we get the chance for that one, or it is included, you included us also in that one, so we can share our content to you, and also we can use your content of 18 university for our student.
That is what we are planning. Exactly, this is the plan, that we want to take up everything at a single platform.
That is the requirement.
Exactly like that. Because lot of dearth of knowledge in terms of e-learning concepts, virtual videos and real videos, and really, so many things are there. But these are scattered and not used by our agricultural community, real community. Because access is not there. Knowledge is about this existence of these kind of facilities not there. That is the major, that but what we are trying to bridge the gap between these things. That is what we are planning.
So if you open that platform for
yeah,
us.
Yeah, that platform, there are two ways. One platform is straight away. Suppose you want to put your platform registered on our, system. It can be just directly, we can provide you URL, everything free of cost to the university, and it will be operational. That is one. Another, the standard portal, which will be coming up. It is coming up shortly. Okay. And in that, it can be added.
Surely, we will participate in that one and also take the benefit of that portal for our student also.
And for creating contents, I think some of the faculty members from Dapoli and even all other universities, they are all participating in that. So
there is a need for the separate MOOC module for agriculture.
Yeah.
Yes. But for agriculture, there is a separate MOOC model platform is required for the national level and based on the common syllabus of the
agriculture. Yeah, MOOC model are essentially required.
Essentially, it is required.
Definitely.
For that purpose, we have to require any authenticated platform that, yes, if this is
our available platform
there,
is very well authenticated and it's all its secrecy and security, everything is well defined. It is a government of India platform. And it is independent to ICAR means not ICAR, ICAR and NARS. NARS total, some total is all state agriculture universities along with the ICAR institution. Yes. Because unless we combine together, we have to strengthen our teaching. And you know that teaching comes through universities, most of the teaching. If you talk ICAR, ICAR is research and development, R&D. So most of, so research and developmental activities, unless these are strengthened properly, nothing will happen. That is the object.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Any other suggestion from anybody?
Sir, my request, sir, other faculty member, please participate in the discussion, sir. Dr. Chaudhary, sir, from Fisheries College.
Sir, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Sir, thank you very much for very nice elaboration on the teaching aspects. Sir, there is one lacuna in our system. See, during this pandemic period, specific software for conducting the classes were not available. For example, we have to depend upon Zoom or Google Meet. These are open sources at this one. So, want to have a specific virtual program developed by ICAR or by NARS?
That is, we are planning exactly what you are telling. It will come out with this type of solution. We are depending on Zoom or Microsoft Access and other things.
MS Teams. To conduct, sir, examination. Well, yeah. Main important thing is lecture can be conducted, but to conduct the examination, the sanctity of the all examination is gone.
Online examination is one of the objective under NAACP component 2. In our component 2 itself, we are creating one platform for online examinations. It is under testing stage and really it is under development stage, if I tell you. By the end of the project, it will be ready. And once such things are created, it will be available for our entire community. See, ICR as a whole, what is ICR? It is a public property. It is available to all state agriculture universities. Funding is going from ICR, ITA is something like control. That's all.
Thank you, sir.
This kind of things will come up. Yes, please. If no more questions, I would like to convey thanks to organizers. Definitely, they are doing a good job, at least to bring awareness. And I'll request all the faculty members to bring awareness among all the students in your respective universities regarding other activities like this creating of your virtual classroom lectures. So all those things are very essential. So that can be taken care of.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Goel sir. Sir Goel sir are already details narrated the e-learnings and all the faculty member having the good discussion. So thank you, sir. Sir, the next speaker is Dr. Sudeep Marawat. He's the in charge and head department from ISRI. I request Dr. Sudeep sir to deliver his lecture. Sudeep sir, please.
Is he available?
Yes, sir. He joined already.
Okay, okay.
New type. Sudeep sir, please. Alka madam is there? Madam, please.
No, I met Alka. Alka is busy in another seminar going on with, some Punjab Agriculture University, Ludhiana. They have also conducted similar kind of seminar, webinar, and I think she's delivering there. After that, she will join her. Alka and Sudeep must be here, I told you so.
Sir, Sudeep sir, please.
We just seen the list.
Mr. Sudeep Marwa, aap dekh lijiye kahan pe abhi online the.
Yes, sir, he already joined, sir. He is in the line, sir.
So, dekh lo.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Whether can you call him?
I will call him, sir.
In the meanwhile, I'll request the Vice Chancellor of DBS KVV Dapoli about what is going on, sir, in your university. What is the status of academic management system? Are you just? So, what is the status of that academic management system in your university? Because it is long due and. Not aware of that. So, what is the status of academic? Because that is again a very important activity, and that we are implementing it almost at 52 universities in the country. In the first phase, 52 remaining.
Academic management system means you are talking about teaching or?
No, there is one portal created by IASRI, and that is made available to the universities free of cost for day-to-day management of the academic activities. Like the student get admission in the university, the day one he will admit the credential and all activities related to the students, related to the teaching, related to the courses offered in the university, related to the which course referred to or given to the which university, and so forth. It is such a wonderful software that from day one to the last day, when a student will leave the university, everything will be digitized. And on the convocation day, or prior to 2 days before, you can print all the degrees in-house within your system itself. You need not just give all data to anybody. Just system, this academic management system will automatically print all the degrees in between some any information over the period. Suppose you want that mark sheet, performance of the students, and then the classes, different kind of courses offered, different kind of degrees offered under not only university, all affiliated and constituent colleges related to your university. That is a very good software, and it has been implemented in many of the universities. To name a few, I can tell you, like G.B. Pant University, Pantnagar. Recently, we have implemented it in University of Agriculture and Horticulture Sciences, Shimoga, Dharwad. It is operational. U.S. Bangalore. So
we have some system. I think Dr. Mr. Chaugule.
You might be having some system, but this system is going to take up
program. It's not there, but Assistant Registrar Chaugule can talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
Student admission and related academic management system, apne paas kya hai, bataiye inko. Chaugule sir.
Haan sir, haan sir. Kam chiran ji.
Kaun sa system? ICIR system use kar rahe ho ya... मतलब IISR ने बनाया हुआ सिस्टम यूज कर रहे हैं या कौन सा सिस्टम यूज कर रहे हैं आप
सर सर एक मिनट सर एग्जाम एग्जाम में थे मैडम आए इतना सर
नॉट एग्जाम व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू द डे 1 स्टूडेंट्स एंटर इन द यूनिवर्सिटी ही गोस टू द रजिस्ट्रार ऑफिस जस्ट फॉर वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट दैट आई हैव बीन एडमिटेड टू योर यूनिवर्सिटी You make the record, you start writing on the big registers or I don't know, on the computer. So straight away, he will be asked to register in that particular portal, day 1. And all activities, whatever are involved, I'm telling you, course management, students management, faculty management, and then teaching management, everything, all related activities can be done online, paperless. No paper from one stage to another stage. Like that professor allocate course X to a particular faculty member. No need to take approval on the paper. It will be approved through different channels. Whatever the process is involved, that will be made accessible in the system itself. So that is an excellent system and it is being implemented. I think many of you might have been attending our seminars, which we are conducting frequently on this academic management system, its capabilities, and its so it has been implemented in almost all the universities, but not made operational. My question is, have you made it operational or even
sir, Goel, sir?
Yes, sir.
Sir, already, sir, the discussion regarding this academic system in our university, sir. Our dean, sir, Dr. Satish Narkadeji, is contacted to the ISRI.
Uh-huh.
But at that time, sir, from ISRI side, they said, as you are in the non-NHEP project, so later on you will be added there if you are in the NHEP project. Sir, the same discussions was held with the Sudeep ji.
Okay.
Sir, now that today, sir, in the last month, we have awarded this NHEP project, sir. So in the next few months, sir, Dr. Satish Narkarji is a dean, sir, our director of instruction, sir, and we are trying to implementing this same software in our university also, sir.
Okay.
Already, sir, discussion was held before 2-3 months, sir.
Because these need operationalization. That is
yes, sir. But at that time, sir, that he told, sir, that your university not in NHP project. So after when you are entering in the NHP project, then we will give this software to you.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So another very important project which is going on for the state agriculture universities is project information and management system. There must be one coordinator or contact person from your university for project information and management system. Where
that is there in implementation. Dr. Torne is aware of that.
Wherein you have to enter the information with regard to all the research projects going on in your university may be funded by any authority, ICR, state government, foreign funding, private funding, whatever it may be. Means the idea I tell you behind that is, ICR itself, we just initiated this project 10 years back, just to have some total of R&D activities going on under ICR. But that is not a complete platform, because R&D is not carried out only in ICR. I'm quite hopeful that State Agriculture University, they are definitely doing very wonderful projects. Even ICR might not have thought of it. So those research projects, unless we add with this particular platform, we will be not doing justice with the information with regard to research and developmental activities in the country as a whole. It will be becoming an archive, and more or less, another important aspect is online management of the project activities. Then you will be able, or your university will be able to have online management of the research projects going on in your university. At present, research projects are going on. I am quite confident.
Dr. Torne, whether he is online?
Pardon?
Dr. Torne, whether he is there, joined from our university, he is aware about that program, and we have been implementing that.
It has been already from our side, ISRI has implemented in all the state 74 agriculture universities, all whatever are there. But the question is, after implementation, you have to upload the brief information with regard to projects which are going on, in the title of the project, then its objectives and the activities, then who are the PI, co-PI, and the funding provided by which agency. And then our target is its outcome and output, expected output and expected outcome. And once we get this kind of platform, you will definitely agree that we'll be able to have a decent assessment for the future, at least. When we just have a PhD student, what do we do? We ask him first foremost thing is, go and do literature search. What has been done so far? So what has been done so far in research and development, it will be a great platform, online platform, wherein a group of people can sit together and have assessment. What kind of projects are going on and what is the future requirement? Some projects might have been going on which are not required at all in future. Some might be lacking, that these are the future requirement and we have not touched it. So that platform is going to really aid us a great benefit for future research and development. And unless we go and think for this properly, we'll not be able to do justice with our, again, agriculture domain. How we'll take it up? So that is this another very important project. And I'm not sure that university is taking this kind of activity, uploading, because it's a very simple project. And I'm sure when it was inaugurated and made available to all the SAUs, I was there. I'm part of that. In developmental activities, I was there. Definitely. It has been developed and now it is being revised for online monitoring. How you can go for online monitoring? So who is the person actually involved in these activities at your...
Dr. Torne, our Associate Director Research.
Yes, please.
Director. He is responsible for using that particular software. He has uploaded quite a bit things.
Few only uploaded. You can see the dashboard if necessary, and very few projects are uploaded. And now I make it very clear that not only the ongoing project, unless we upload the project taken in the past, will not be able to have real assessment what was done by in the past. As in ICR, Project Information Management System project, we have more than 15,000 research project information. And even the project which were taken during 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, because we have to compare what was done in those days. There may be few things which were initiated at that time, and now it is again the time to just restart. It may happen. Somebody might have started a very good problem, and that somehow it could not be processed further. It could not be taken up for future development. So that is the basic requirement of this. So first we have to start with the current ongoing project and then keep on adding the project which were taken up in the past. So this will be a great archive of R&D activities of our country. And this is already, it has been initiated. It is very well under NIHP component. 2. This is one activity which again needs initiative from our senior management, vice chancellor, dean, director, and this. Unless they put in some pressure on this, it will not be at par. So again, this is my request to the concerned people at the university. Please look into it.
Hello, sir.
Sir, I will just add one thing.
Yes.
I'm Dr. Chaudhary from Ratnagiri College of Fisheries, Ratnagiri. Sir, regarding this academic management system, no, our university has adopted from last year AUAMS.in.
Ah, correct.
So that is being adopted, and one workshop is already held. Uh-huh. And during this particular year, our students are registering. We are giving our registration to the student from this particular academic management system. Our teachers, they are also trying to upload the syllabus and they will also upload the results and all those things through this academic management system. We have adopted, sir.
You have adopted. So is it really become
our university has adopted. Yes,
I am quite happy. But operational doesn't mean registration only. Registration is the initial seed.
Yes, sir.
Initial seed we have put in the farm.
Yes,
it has to grow. Grow in the sense that once a teacher is registered, what are his responsibilities? Everything he will do online only.
Online.
He will not write a line on the paper.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Then professor will allocate courses to different. He will do online. Nothing. And he will approve online. Everything will go online.
Sir, all teachers are registered now. They have got their email addresses and registration.
That is the seed. Yes, sir. I mean, register. Teachers registration definitely the initial seed, definitely.
Yes,
but we need real operational education. Day-to-day activities must be taken care of.
Yes, sir, we'll do, sir.
System.
Yes.
My objective is that.
Goel sir, good afternoon. We have implemented that AUPMS, Agriculture University Project Management Information System.
Yeah,
and we have all the projects, ASAPs and Excel funded projects we have uploaded.
Yeah.
To the website, and we are monitoring it.
So that is what is a good thing. I wanted to remind that not only the current project, you take up the project which were already completed in the past. Their PI may not be available, but you just add that also.
Okay.
I think now Dr.
Dr. Sudeep has joined
online.
The real creator of all these
activities. Give some opportunity to talk to him now.
So now he is with us. He will take. I will just definitely hand over the platform to Dr. Sudeep Marwa, our sweet beloved creator. He has really given a very big boost to these activities, rather AMS, PIMS, or this virtual reality, as I discussed everything. So he is the originator. So definitely, on my behalf, I would like to welcome my beloved PI, Dr. Sudeep Marwa.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sawant.
Thank you.
I request Dr. Sudeep ji, sir, to have the next topic discussions.
Thank you all. Sorry, if, I could not. I missed the last half an hour or so, because there was a parallel program on Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, and we were having a lecture there for farmers, which was broadcasting, and somehow these two things we couldn't avoid going side by side. Sir, as I was listening, and as the topic is brainstorming session, so I definitely go along with whatever all of you are saying, that e-office is very important and is being used across India. And what the first speaker ours is explaining, e-office thing, we are using same. I want to say that you can surely go on it. And this is one of the best product which NIC has developed till date. And all of that is being used across India in multiple organizations. And I believe it has passed over 1,000 implementations. Am I right, Garjaji? So around 1,000 plus implementations of e-office. So there is no point. This is a standard product. The only thing is people have deployed it at either it from NIC or like we have done it, we have done it from ISRI data center. So we got this product from NIC, and since at that particular point of time, NIC told us that they don't have that much space, plus we have our own LDAP and other things. Email 25,000 mailboxes are there with us in our ICR data center. So it was planned in a way that we should have our own implementation of e-office supported by NIC. So in that case, the modalities were that since it is a big implementation, that we want to have a single e-office implementation for all 113 ICR institutions. So it's not like that it's a separate instance for each institute. Rather than we have a single instance starting from the ICR headquarters, and under that we have created all the childs, that means child organizations. And there are 113 of those. So in one go, we have implemented 113 organizations from ICR data center, and using our own LDAP and email account. That account is icrgov.in. So @icrgov.in. And through that, we have implemented it. And during the first lockdown, the efficacy is like before the pandemic, we were struggling to implement it. And in since August 2019 till February 2020, out of 113, we could implement only 33 organizations. By going there, by implementing and then convincing them, motivating them, onboarding them. So it was really a tough time. But as the COVID struck, although it was a blessing in disguise, and during the first lockdown, we got a clear instruction that it has to be implemented across all 113 institutions. And from 23rd to 24th March, till 15th May, that means during the peak lockdown period, we had a series of meetings and demonstration on virtual platforms like MS Teams and Zoom, etc. And we could implement in all 113 organizations, right? So during that period itself, we could do it. The only things are modalities which you have to see as at a part of your university, how to do it. Whether you want to get it done from NIC servers or you want to have your own servers in place, those things are there. So your local NIC office will guide properly. Or if there is a, I don't say as of now, I don't commit, I don't know actually whether we could do it or not. But if a central decision is taken, at the Vice Chancellor Conference, that all universities have to adopt it and it has to be done through ISRI, then as we did it for ICR all 113 organization, we could take up a because we have all that experience for implementing it 113 organization, we can do it for all 70 EUs also. So, but that decision has to be taken at some VC conference level or something like that. Going further so that is one thing. In the initial remarks, Honorable VC sir was saying that whether we have to go for it, whether it implements all the government procedures or not. So yes, e-office is a product which is tailor-made for government purpose and tailor-made and developed by NIC. So there is no hitch on it. And if you, Mr. Garje has obviously shown it on it, but I can, if you want me to also share the live screenshots, I can do it. Sir, bataiye, if you want to show the whatever we have implemented through my login, I can show it in once. But if you want me to go ahead and with tell you the...
Marwa sahab. Marwa sahab, I was just thinking that since this is a brainstorming, I would like you to share some of the your experiences in your own institute while implementing e-offices. What are the hitches? What are the problems, issues?
Right.
Where you got stuck? Because when I was in ICAR, we were trying to implement the system prepared by IBM.
Hmm.
And we had a lot of difficulties. I haven't seen such a useless system so far. And I left ICAR 3 years back, nothing was implemented. And every time in director's conference, we used to have a lot of useless discussions to implement that. I would like to implement some office system in such a way that we don't get into stuck into such kind of things. Because, ICAR was still a bit of a learned system where all scientists and many of the higher educated people were involved. And a lot of consolidated, coordinated efforts were made. In university, we would not be able to do that so often. So, where the things were were in difficulties? Garje saab, hamare paas char paas ghante discuss kiye hai. But still.
Right.
One of the things which he came and told us that we got to have once the simple email system in our uniform email system. And Dr. Kolle knows we made some efforts to implement a uniform email system. It's not that so easy. Yeah, it can be implemented.
No, sir.
Want your input on critical aspects. Kahan pe bottlenecks hai? Kahan pe we should be paying more attention to?
Sir, that's true. Let me again say that implementing the enterprise-wide systems like ERP, e-office and other things, even AMS, are never an easy job. सबसे पहले और सबसे बड़ी बात है लोगों का माइंडसेट को चेंज करना और ये कहना और मानना कि यस हम ये काम करेंगे. सारी चीजें घूम फिर के इस एक पॉइंट पे आ जाती है कि विलिंगनेस ऑफ द पीपल टू डू इट राइट. सो वेदर यू वॉन्ट टू डू इट सी यही चीज अगर आप इवन IBM के सिस्टम को भी लेके चले ERP को भी लेके चले. Let me tell you once again, the system was fantastic. ठीक है, from a technical point of view. ठीक है, user point of view पे भी आएंगे. यही system, जैसे e-office एक बहुत अच्छा system है, जिसकी 1000 से ऊपर implementation हो गई है. कोई भी system ऐसा नहीं हो सकता जो जिसकी 1000 implementation हो जाए, मतलब 1000 organizations ले लें, 1000 2000 organizations, और वो system evolve ना हुआ हो और उसने अडेप्टेशन ना हुई हो और वो आगे चल के सारी सुविधाएं प्रोवाइड नहीं कर रहा हो. ऐसा नहीं होता. अगर जो सिस्टम एक इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, दो इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, पांच इम्प्लीमेंटेशन जी जाएगा, लेकिन अगर वो अच्छा नहीं है तो वो मर जाएगा. तो ये जो सिस्टम्स हैं उसमें कहीं ना कहीं हमें देखना होता है कि क्या अडॉप्टेशन है, क्या आईटी रेडीनेस है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की जो उसको अडॉप्ट कर रही है. ठीक है. सो आईटी, जब हमने ICR में ERP शुरू किया था, क्योंकि बातें ये हो रही हैं कि कैसे हम आपकी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को उन सब हिकअप से बचा सके जो पहले हमने झेली हैं, तो आप देखेंगे कि उस टाइम पे IT की रेडीनेस ICR में बहुत कम थी. कोई एक ऐसा सिस्टम ही नहीं आज तक पैदा हुआ था जो आपने 113 ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में एक साथ लगाया. सो वो पहला अटेम्प्ट था कि आप किसी एक 113 ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में एक स्टैंडर्डाइज सोल्यूशन लाए. स्टैंडर्डाइज सोल्यूशन इन अ वे कि आपके पास ICR में उस टाइम पे एक यूनिक आईडी भी नहीं थी, एम्प्लॉय आईडी भी नहीं थी. फॉरगेट अबाउट सिस्टम. अगर आप किसी को एक बोलो कि मेरा एम्प्लॉय आईडी क्या है ICR का, तो वो भी नहीं था. ठीक है. तो आप जब सिस्टम इंप्लीमेंट करना चाहते हो तो ये सारी चीजें प्री रिक्विजिट होती है. अगर किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में ये सारी स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन और सारी चीजें पहले से एग्जिस्ट करती है तो सिस्टम काफी स्मूथली अडॉप्ट होते हैं। बट अगर ये सारी चीजें ही नहीं होती हैं, पहले से ही स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन नहीं होता है, पहले से ही अलग अलग जो डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैं वो अलग अलग काम कर रही होती हैं, तो बहुत मुश्किल होता है। और ये चीज मैं अभी जैसे हमने बताया कि आपको भी पता है एकेडमिक मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम अभी 51 यूनिवर्सिटीज में चल रहा है, हमारे पास 70 यूनिवर्सिटीज हैं एग्रीकल्चर, चार तो डिफरेंट कॉलेजेस हैं जैसे एमयू पीएचयू वाले, बट 70 यूनिवर्सिटीज हैं। उन 70 यूनिवर्सिटी में अगर मैं एक यूनिवर्सिटी को भी उठा लेता था और उसको देखता था तो अमंग डिफरेंट कॉलेजेस इटसेल्फ, अगर एक यूनिवर्सिटी के 6 कॉलेज हैं तो 6 कॉलेज में भी अगर आप माइन्यूट लेवल पे देखे जाए तो प्रोसीजरली डिफरेंट प्रोसीजर अडॉप्ट होते हैं। यहां तक की कमियां भी हमने पकड़ी हैं कि फीस भी अलग अलग ली जा रही है एक ही प्रोग्राम के लिए, उसमें किसी ने इंश्योरेंस बिल्ट इन कर दी, किसी ने नहीं कर दी, किसी ने कभी एक सर्कुलर निकला होगा उसमें ये फीस लेनी थी तो वो वही फीस लिया जा रहा है, दूसरा सर्कुलर निकल गया है कि अब ये नहीं लेनी है तो उसने बंद ही नहीं करी है। तो और डिफरेंट लेवल पे डिफरेंट तरह की स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन प्रॉब्लम्स एग्जिस्ट करती रहती हैं और वो पकड़ में नहीं आती है जब तक किसी को एक सेंट्रल डैशबोर्ड के ऊपर वो सारी चीजें दिखाई ना जाए। ठीक है, तो जब वो सेंट्रल डैशबोर्ड पे दिखती हैं चीजें तो जो है वो पकड़ी जाती हैं, और उसके बाद फिर रादर देन गोइंग फॉर स्मूथ आईटी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन सारी ताकत जुड़ जाती है उन प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करने के लिए जो इनहेरेंट है। ठीक है, वो इनहेरेंट प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व किए बिना आप आगे नहीं बढ़ सकते हो, तो और उस टाइम पे दोबारा भी आपको जो है टॉप मैनेजमेंट की सबसे ज्यादा जरूरत पड़ती है, क्योंकि बिना टॉप मैनेजमेंट के पॉलिसी डिसीजन हुए बिना आप कोई काम आगे नहीं कर सकते हो। सो दो चीजें साथ साथ चलती हैं हमेशा इसके अंदर, एक आपका आईटी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन है जो एक नया सॉफ्टवेयर आप एंटरप्राइज लेवल पे बिल्ट इन करना चाह रहे हो, और दूसरा है आपके बीपीआर, जो मैंने ये चीजें बोली सरल भाषा में टेक्निकली वी कॉल्ड एज बीपीआर, दैट इज बिजनेस प्रोसेस री इंजीनियरिंग। जिस प्रोसेस से आप काम करते हो वो प्रोसेस को री इंजीनियर करना पड़ता है, जब री इंजीनियर करना पड़ता है तो सारी पद्धतियां चेंज करनी पड़ती हैं। ठीक है, बहुत बार आप अगर देखेंगे तो आपको सिस्टम्स लोग बना लेते हैं, एक काम और होता है इन सब कामों में कि भाई आपने स्टाफिंग जैसे करी है, आपने पहले जो सालों से स्टाफिंग चलती आ रही है, सेक्शन चलते आ रहे हैं आपके यूनिवर्सिटीज में, उनके अंदर जो वर्कफोर्स चलती आ रही है वो उसी हिसाब से काम करती रहेगी। ठीक है, आपका जैसे ही सिस्टम आता है तो वर्कलोड का रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हो जाता है, तो कई बार तो आपको जो काम करने हैं जैसे ई ऑफिस के संदर्भ में बोलते हैं, इसके अंदर काफी रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन होता है। अगर आपका जहां से शुरू में फाइल स्कैन होनी है, जैसे लेटर आया, अभी आपके पास जो सबसे मैं कहूंगा जनरली मैंने देखा, आपकी यूनिवर्सिटी के लिए नहीं कह रहा हूँ, आपको नहीं उसके लिए नहीं कह रहा हूँ, बट जनरली जो मैंने देखा है कि जो आपका रिसीट विभाग होता है उसके अंदर वो उतना चुस्त नहीं होता है। ठीक है, बाकी विभागों के मुकाबले। ठीक है, तो रिसीट और डिस्पैच जो विभाग होता है उसमें लोग के पास कंप्यूटर भी पता है नहीं है, स्कैनर्स भी हैं या नहीं है। सो जो नई चिट्ठी आ रही है अभी, आप देखो कि जो चिट्ठी आएगी वो 50 जगहों पे लैंड करेगी आपके इंस्टीट्यूट में। ठीक है, हर डीन को कर रही होगी, हर प्रोफेसर को भी कर रही होगी, कोई कहीं से चिट्ठी आ रही है, कोई कहीं से आ रही है, और वो आके आपको ई ऑफिस में ई रिसीट की तरह बनानी है। ठीक है, ऑल दो ये सॉफ्टवेयर अलाउ करता है किसी को भी ई रिसीट बनाने का, किसी को भी फाइल शुरू करने का, बट वो सही तरीका नहीं होता। सही तरीका तो ये होता है कि आपको एक जगह पे आपकी सारी रिसीट आ जाए, वहां पे आप दो लोगों को लगा दो जो अच्छे से स्कैनिंग करते हो, उनका सुबह से शाम तक यही है कि स्कैन करके भेज दो, कॉन्फिडेंशियल लेटर्स को छोड़ दो जो 2-5% होंगे, बट मैक्सिमम चिट्ठियां जो हैं बाहर से जो आ रही हैं वो एक ही सेक्शन में आए, वो वहां से फटाफट स्कैन हो और उसके बाद इंडिविजुअली किसी किसी को चली जाए, नहीं तो आपको सब ये लोग बोलेंगे कि सर काम कैसे करें, स्कैनर नहीं है हमारे पास। ठीक है, सबसे पहले जरूरत पड़ेगी कि स्कैनर नहीं है, स्कैनर नहीं है, जबकि स्कैनर कितनों को चाहिए। ठीक है, मैक्सिमम चीजें आज की रेट में तो उसमें भी अटैच होके आ जाती हैं, तो स्कैनर की मेरे को नहीं लगता बहुत ज्यादा जरूरत है, लेकिन रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज की बहुत जरूरत है कि किसी सेक्शन में काम बढ़ जाएगा, किसी सेक्शन में काम कम हो जाएगा ये ऑफिस के आने से। तो वो एक सोचना है कि क्या कहाँ पे काम बढ़ रहा है, कहाँ पे काम कम हो रहा है, अगर आपको इसकी स्मूथ और बढ़िया इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करनी है। तो जो वर्कलोड कमेटी बना के या किसी तरीके से करके उसको दोबारा रीऑर्गेनाइज थोड़ा सा करने की जरूरत होती है।
वर्कलोड कमेटी
ठीक है, जो एसेस करे कि कहाँ पे क्या करा जा सकता है, ठीक है, कितना वर्कलोड पड़ेगा, किसका कम होगा, किसी का ज्यादा होगा, तो अकॉर्डिंगली मैन पावर वहां से आप शिफ्टिंग करोगे। वो नहीं करता है कोई मैक्सिमम टाइम पे, देखा है कि उस पे तो सबसे ज्यादा अडिग रहते हैं, नहीं वो नहीं चेंज करना है, तो वो एक बहुत मुसीबत है जिसकी वजह से काफी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में मैं नहीं कहता भी फेल हो जाता है इसकी वजह से, इस वजह से फेल कभी नहीं होता है लेकिन डिले होता है, ठीक है। सो ये है दूसरा पॉइंट जो है बेसिक आईटी रेडीनेस, ठीक है, बेसिक आईटी नॉलेज ऑफ द स्टाफ, वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। ये चीज हमने ईआरपी में देखी शुरू से, ठीक है, और कई बार देखी कि बिल्कुल उल्टा तरीका देखा हमने, मतलब अगर आप उसको क्रिटिकली एनालाइज करें कि जो आपका लोअर स्टाफ है वो शुरू में सबसे ज्यादा चिल्लाया कि हम नहीं कर पा रहे ईआरपी, ईआरपी बहुत मुश्किल है, ये है वो है, नहीं कर पा रहे। दो साल के बाद, तीन साल के बाद नीचे वाला सारा स्टाफ कर रहा था, और आपको सर हैरानी होगी आज की डेट में आईबीएम को छोड़े दो डेढ़ साल हो गया, ठीक है, 2020 जुलाई में जस्ट आफ्टर लॉकडाउन आईबीएम लेफ्ट आईसीआर, और एकल को भी हमने सीधा बैकग्राउंड में कंटिन्यू नहीं किया, अगस्त में उन्होंने छोड़ दिया। सिस्टम इज स्टिल फंक्शनिंग इन ऑल वेज विदाउट आईबीएम, विदाउट ओरेकल। आज भी आईसीआर में हर साल के 2.5 से 3 लाख बिल बन रहे हैं, ठीक है, कोई अभी बात नहीं कर रहा, सब काम स्मूथली चल रहा है, ठीक है। तो होता यह है कि जो अकाउंट ऑफिसर लेवल है या एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर लेवल है, वो लोग हमेशा जो है यही देखते थे कि नीचे वाले तो कर रहे हैं, लेकिन हम खुद सिस्टम में नहीं देखेंगे, खुल के जाके लॉगिन नहीं करेंगे, करके काम नहीं देखेंगे, ठीक है, वो खाली डिपेंडेंट रहेंगे नीचे वालों के लिए। अच्छा तुमने कर दिया तो ठीक है, मेरे को तो अभी भी प्रिंट करके ही दे दो और मैं इस पे साइन मार देता हूँ। अगर उस लेवल पे एफर्ट नहीं होता है तो दिक्कत है। और मैंने देखा जिस जिस अकाउंट ऑफिसर और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर ने पेंस लेके काम किया, उन्होंने पूरा 1-to-1 मैचिंग करके अपना एनुअल अकाउंट भी ईआरपी से निकाला। और मेरे पास उदाहरण है कि एक किन किन नाम से मैं जानता हूँ कि किन किन अकाउंट ऑफिसर ने बोला और मुझे बुला के स्पेशली दिखाया, सर देखो हमने 100% मैच करके चलाया हुआ। कुछ मॉड्यूल्स तकनीकी रूप से बहुत ही मुश्किल होते हैं करने, उसमें से एक मॉड्यूल है एसेट मैनेजमेंट, ठीक है। एसेट मैनेजमेंट अगर एक इंस्टीट्यूशन 50 साल से 100 साल से चल रहा है, उसके सारे एसेट्स का ब्यौरा एक साथ लेके आना बहुत मुश्किल है, ठीक है। उसमें आपको तमाम तरह की कमियां भी दिखेंगी, बीच में रजिस्टर्स के अंदर खामियां भी दिखेंगी, और कई बार एसेट आपको फिजिकली नहीं दिख रहा, कई बार ये भी होता कि कई पुराने का भी जब आपने जो इसको सेल किया है नॉन असेट्स, मतलब नॉन परफॉर्मिंग असेट्स को, वो सारे ढंग से कॉपी करके उसमें जो असेट रजिस्टर है उसमें क्लोज नहीं किए गए, तो ये जो बुनियादी चीजें हैं वो नहीं हुई है, तो आईटी सॉफ्टवेयर अकेला क्या कर लेगा, तो वो नहीं हो सकता है। तो वो इस तरह के मॉड्यूल बहुत ट्रिकी होते हैं और टफ होते हैं, तो आपको एक लास्ट डेट लेनी ही पड़ती है कि इससे पहले का हम बुक में चलाएंगे, इससे हमें नहीं मालूम, जो बुक में हुआ हुआ, इसके बाद के जो है अब आपसे जो एसेट्स हम खरीद रहे हैं उसकी प्रॉपर हम कॉस्टिंग करें और वही डेप्रिसिएशन भी सारे लगा के सब कुछ उसका एनुअल अकाउंट में आए, तो वहां पे एक 100% मैनुअल दिक्कत नहीं है। दूसरा जो मैं जब माइंडसेट की बात कह रहा था, तो माइंडसेट में एक चीज रहती है सबका, ऑल्दो अब कंप्यूटर 01 पे चलता है, लेकिन लोगों के दिमाग में ये रहता है कि या तो मैं कुछ नहीं करूंगा या मैं या सब कुछ करूंगा ऐसे ही सॉफ्टवेयर के लिए, मतलब बीच की ऐसा नहीं है कि अच्छा आप सॉफ्टवेयर खरीद लिया, आप सब कुछ यही करेगा, अब हम कुछ नहीं करेंगे, हम खाली एक बटन दबाएंगे सब कुछ होके आ जाना चाहिए। आज तक आप एक रिपोर्ट को बनाने के लिए 2 हफ्ते लगा रहे थे, अगर आपको सॉफ्टवेयर की मदद से आपको वो रिपोर्ट जो है 3 घंटे में मिल जा रही है, 2 घंटे में मिल जा रही है, तो उसकी अप्रिशिएशन ना हो के वो कहेंगे नहीं ये तुमको दो मिनट में मिलनी चाहिए और मुझे कुछ नहीं करना, वो एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज रहता है। वो रिपोर्ट भी आपको मिल जाएगी दो मिनट में, लेकिन हो सकता है दूसरी या तीसरी बार मिले। जब पहली बार आप वो रिपोर्ट चाह रहे हो सकता है वो नहीं मिलेगी आपको, हो सकता है कि रीप्रोग्रामिंग करनी पड़े, कुछ करना पड़े, दो दिन तीन दिन चार दिन आपको लगे। और अगर आपको वो रिपीटेटिव वो रिपोर्ट चाहिए तो अगली बार से दो तीन बार से वो करके वो स्मूथ हो जाएगी। तो कितनी तरह की रिपोर्ट्स चाहिए आपको आपको सिस्टम के लिए, स्पेशली जब आप अकाउंट्स की बात कर रहे थे, मैं उसके साथ कह रहा हूँ ई ऑफिस में मेरे को कोई दिक्कत नहीं है क्योंकि ई ऑफिस अपने में एक अब बिल्कुल सुलझा हुआ सिस्टम है। ठीक है, वहां पे ई ऑफिस करने में बस आपको दो तीन चीजें चाहिए। आपका जो एक लेवल होता है उसमें ईएमडी क्रिएशन, ठीक है। सो ईएमडी क्रिएशन पे अगर आपकी हायरार्की बड़ी वेल डिफाइंड है और आपने अच्छे से बना ली है, फिर आगे जाके कोई खास प्रॉब्लम नहीं आती, ठीक है, डे टू डे ऑपरेशंस में। सो जो आपकी सेंट्रल टीम है जो ईआरपी को इंप्लीमेंट करेगी, तीन से चार लोग, वो अच्छे से ट्रेंड होने चाहिए पूरे प्रोसेस के कि ईएमडी कैसे बनानी है, रोल्स कैसे असाइन करने हैं, हायरार्की कैसे सेट करनी है, कभी कोई आदमी ट्रांसफर हो रहा है एक जगह से दूसरी जगह तो कैसे करना है, एक आदमी की प्रमोशन हो रही है एक जगह से दूसरी जगह हाई लेवल पे तो उसके रोल्स कैसे चेंज करने हैं। बड़ी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंदर इसी में ही काफी एफर्ट लगता है, छोटी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में उतना नहीं लगता, लेकिन फिर भी अगर वहां पे गलती होती है तो वो गलती कई बार समझ में भी नहीं आती और कई बार बहुत दिनों बाद पकड़ी जाती है और उसको डिबग करने में और उसको करने में बहुत दिक्कत होती है। तो आपकी सेंट्रल कोर टीम मजबूत होनी मस्ट है और वो जो है आप उस पे, एनआईसी है सामने मेरे लेकिन आप प्लीज डोंट माइंड इट, बट एनआईसी पे आप डिपेंडेंट नहीं रह सकते। एनआईसी आपके घर की प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करने नहीं आएगा, ठीक है। एनआईसी आपके ट्रेनर्स को ट्रेन कर देगा, ठीक है, वो आपके डेली के वन टू वन इशू में नहीं आएगा कभी भी, ठीक है। आप बोलोगे चार आदमी को ट्रेन करना है, चार को कर देगा, आपको भी आठ को करना है, आठ को कर देगा, ठीक है। लेकिन आपको ये बोले कि मेरे यहाँ आके अब ये अटक रहा है और इसको बार बार आके देखे और आपका आदमी बार बार वही गलती करता रहे किसी ना किसी तरीके से, तो वो बार बार वो पूरे भूसे में से सुई ढूंढ के निकाल के देते रहे आपको, वो नहीं होगा, ठीक है। तो आपको अपनी स्ट्रॉन्ग इंटरनल टीम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन की बनानी ही बनानी है, ठीक है। एनआईसी आपको ट्रेनर्स और ट्रेनर कंसेप्ट के ऊपर आपके लोगों को ट्रेन कर देगा, लेकिन एक्चुअल काम आपके लोगों को ही करना पड़ेगा। तो ये सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट बात है और फिर वो उस पर डिपेंडेंट है कि आप होस्टिंग कहाँ करते हैं। अगर एनआईसी पे करते हैं तो एटलीस्ट होस्टिंग की जिम्मेवारी आपकी नहीं है, दे विल अपग्रेड द वर्जन, दे विल डू एवरीथिंग एल्स। बट अगर वो आप अपने यहाँ करते हैं या कुछ ऐसे अलग तरीके पे करते हैं तो वो जिम्मेवारी भी आपकी हो जाती है, विच इज अगेन अ बिग टास्क, ठीक है। उसके लिए अगर आपको अगेन सिस्टम एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, डेटाबेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन और उस लेवल के आपको एटलीस्ट चार से पांच लोग अच्छे चाहिए, ठीक है। तो ये कॉस्ट तो है ही है, तो अगर एनआईसी उसकी जिम्मेवारी लेता है तो एटलीस्ट आप सर्वर लेवल से फ्री हैं और आपको खाली अपना इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इंटरनल इन हाउस का देखना है। पीरियोडिक रिव्यूज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, ठीक है। एक सेंट्रल कमेटी, दो, आई बिलीव यू शुड हैव टू कमेटीज फॉर दिस, either you implement e-office or AMS or any software, for each software implementation at least two committees you should constitute, one at the lower level and one at the higher level which is chaired by you. और नीचे वाली कमेटी डेली ऑपरेशंस को देखे कि क्या हो रहा है क्या नहीं हो रहा है, एक आदमी नहीं, उसके अंदर जो है आपके हर कॉलेज के एक एक दो दो आदमी हो सकते हैं, ठीक है। वो उसको मंथली मीटिंग ले और क्वार्टरली मीटिंग आप लो, सो सारे इश्यूज जो हैं वो क्वार्टरली बेसिस के ऊपर आपके सामने आए और जो दूसरी मीटिंग है उसको मंथली आए, और उसका जो मेंबर सेक्रेटरी हो वो शुड बी हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द होल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन। जो मेंबर सेक्रेटरी होगा नीचे वाली कमेटी का या ऊपर वाली कमेटी का, दोनों का सेम भी हो सकता है, वो शुड बी द लीड इम्प्लीमेंट supporting person of that software in your university. जब तक क्लियरली आप किसी एक को रिस्पॉन्सिबल नहीं बनाओगे टू गेट इट डन और उसको कंप्लीट राइट्स नहीं दोगे, तब तक सॉफ्टवेयर को इम्प्लीमेंट करने के लिए कोई नहीं सुनता।
अच्छा मरवा साहब, एक और एक पॉइंट आपसे एक्सपेक्ट करता हूं मैं बोलने में। द यूनिवर्सिटी ऐसा नहीं है कि दे आर नॉट यूजिंग एनी सॉफ्टवेयर।
आई नो
In isolation, various departments, various wings are using some softwares. I mean, education department has some softwares. Then my assistant registrar group is using some software for their management. The R&D research departments are using, I mean, like your this project monitoring software. Now, when we go for office, e-office, what do we do? We go for a separate modules for jahan gaps hai, wahan pe separate modules le le, and then us module se existing software ko link kare.
Nahin, sir. Let's be very clear on what we are doing now. ठीक है, एक आप वो भी कर सकते हैं, वो आगे जाके बात करेंगे कि एक रोड मैप होना चाहिए, वो कहीं नहीं होता। सो आज एक आप कमेटी बिठा लो, सब कुछ बिठा लो, दो चार बाहर से एक्सपर्ट भी लो और आप देखो कि 5 साल में 10 साल में आप कहाँ जाना चाहते हो, तो आपके पास एक रोड मैप होना चाहिए, वो एक लार्जर पिक्चर है। ठीक है, तो वो होना ही चाहिए किसी एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का आई टी रोड मैप कि गोइंग फर्दर वो कैसे करेंगे। लेकिन बिफोर दैट जो भी आपने एक क्वेश्चन उठाया, ई ऑफिस क्या है, मतलब आई नो गर्जे साहब हैज टोल्ड इन डिटेल, बट फिर भी मैं 2 मिनट में दोबारा संक्षेप में बताऊंगा कि अपनी समझ से कि ई ऑफिस किस लिए है और क्यों है, और उसमें बिल्कुल भी दिमाग में कंफ्यूजन नहीं होना चाहिए किसी के भी, क्योंकि ये सवाल बार बार उठता है कि ई ऑफिस क्या। ई ऑफिस आपकी जो डिसीजन मेकिंग है, जो आपकी ग्रीन फाइल है, उसको ऑटोमेट करता है, जबकि दूसरे सॉफ्टवेयर जो हैं, चाहे वो कंप्लीट एक सेंट्रल ईआरपी सॉल्यूशन ले लो या आपके डिफरेंट दूसरे दो, वो आपकी रिकॉर्ड लेवल की रिकॉर्ड कीपिंग के लिए और उस सॉल्यूशन के लिए होते हैं। मतलब कि अगर आपको एक रिपोर्ट निकालनी है किसी एक सॉफ्टवेयर में से अकाउंट्स के लिए, अकाउंट्स के फिगर्स की, एनुअल अकाउंट्स के लिए, इसके लिए प्रोजेक्ट्स के लिए प्रोजेक्ट्स की फिगर्स, या किसी और चीज के लिए, उससे ई ऑफिस का सीधा कोई लेना देना नहीं है। ठीक है, ई ऑफिस आपको क्या करता है, जो आपकी ग्रीन फाइल में सारी डिसीजन मेकिंग्स होती हैं, ठीक है, उसको एसिंक्रोनस मोड में सॉल्यूशन देता है। एसिंक्रोनस मतलब कि आपने जैसे फाइल में लिख दिया, तो आप तो फाइल पे कुछ भी लिख सकते हो ना, टेबल बना दोगे तो मतलब ग्रीन शीट पे कुछ भी, कि हर फाइल हर जगह चलती है, तो सारी डिसीजन मेकिंग्स को वो ऑटोमेट कर देता है। ठीक है, सो इसके बाद होता क्या है कि आप जनरली ई ऑफिस को सीधा इंटीग्रेट नहीं करते हो किसी चीज से। आपके पास मान लो एक रिपोर्ट आई किसी एक सॉफ्टवेयर से और आपने उसके लिए अप्रूवल के लिए आगे डाला है। सो मान लो अकाउंट्स का ही बना, तो अकाउंट्स की उसने रिपोर्ट पूरी जनरेट कर दी, एनुअल अकाउंट का एक फिगर, और आपकी ई ऑफिस में आपको लिख के दे दिया कि जो है ये रिपोर्ट साथ में संलग्न है, कृपया इसको अप्रूवल के लिए देखें। तो वो आपने उसको उसमें अटैच है, आप उसको अप्रूवल कर देंगे। तो जो आपकी मेन ऑडिटिंग की रिक्वायरमेंट है और आगे डिसीजन मेकिंग है, जो ग्रीन फाइल चलती थी, ग्रीन नोट शीट चलती थी, उसको ऑटोमेट करता है। इससे और कोई चीज का लेना देना नहीं है। गोइंग फर्दर, एक इंस्टीट्यूशन के अंदर आपको जनरली लोग जब इतने सारे सॉफ्टवेयर बनाते हैं तो आपस में डेटा एक्सचेंज की जरूरत होती है एक सॉफ्टवेयर से दूसरे सॉफ्टवेयर में, नहीं तो क्या होता है, डुप्लीकेशन ऑफ वर्क होता है। ठीक है, काम तब भी हो जाता है लेकिन आपको कुछ पार्ट ऑफ द वर्क जो है डुप्लीकेट करना पड़ता है, जहां जहां पे वो सॉफ्टवेयर एक दूसरे से टच कर रहे हैं वहां पे वो आपको इंटरफेस को या किसी तरीके से उस काम को दोबारा करना पड़ता है, अगर आप सारे सॉफ्टवेयर इंटीग्रेटेड नहीं है। और सारे सॉफ्टवेयर इंटीग्रेटेड होते नहीं है आज की डेट में, ट्रांजिशन टाइम है, बहुत सारी चीजें बन रही है, गवर्नमेंट की बहुत सारी पॉलिसीज चेंज होती जा रही है, हम एक चीज बनाने की कोशिश करते हैं दूसरी ऊपर से आ जाती है, गाइडलाइंस कुछ हो जाता है, ये हो जाता है, तो वो नहीं है। तो कम से कम एक काम बड़े आसानी से किया जा सकता है जो करते करना भी चाहिए, वो एक एटलीस्ट आप सिंगल साइन ऑन की तरफ बढ़ जाए। ठीक है, तो सेंट्रल सिंगल साइन ऑन की तरफ बढ़ जाए, कि अगर आपको एक ई ऑफिस में जो लॉगिन आईडी यूज करेंगे, यूजर आईडी पासवर्ड, वो एक सेंट्रल जो ऑथेंटिकेशन रिपोजिटरी है उससे जो है रजिस्ट्री है उससे आप ऑथेंटिकेट कर लें। उस एक सिंगल चीज से ही आपका ईमेल चलना चाहिए, उस एक सिंगल लॉगिन आईडी से ही ऑफिस चलना चाहिए, उसी सिंगल आईडी से आपका प्रोजेक्ट वाला सॉल्व होना चाहिए, उसी सिंगल आईडी से एकेडमिक मैनेजमेंट चलना चाहिए, उसी सिंगल आईडी से आपको जो है अकाउंट्स का सॉफ्टवेयर चलना चाहिए। तो विद अ सिंगल यूजर आईडी पासवर्ड विच इज फुल्ली प्रोटेक्टेड, आप एटलीस्ट एक इंटरफेस ले आइए जिसमें आपको एक बार लॉग इन कर गए तो आपको सारी चीजें दिख रही हैं। तो फर्स्ट लेवल इज दैट, ठीक है। उसके बाद नेक्स्ट लेवल पे आप जा सकते हैं कि आप धीरे धीरे आप देखें कि आज की डेट में दूसरा तरीका जो है किसी भी सॉफ्टवेयर को चलते हुए सॉफ्टवेयर जिससे आप खुश हैं कि भाई वो अपने में पूरा सही है, जुड़ नहीं रहा दूसरे से कोई बात नहीं, लेकिन अपने में मेरा कंप्लीट है और मेरा सारा काम कर रहा है। तो अगर ऐसा सॉफ्टवेयर है उनको अलग गिनती में रख लीजिए और उनको काम कर लेने दीजिए, और उनके ऊपर एक और एक इंटरफेस लग जाता है जिसको हम API लेवल से हम इंटीग्रेट कर लेते हैं एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्रामर इंटरफेस से, जो भी इंफॉर्मेशन इधर से चाहिए और दूसरे सॉफ्टवेयर में ले आएंगे और एक उसका ऊपर एक नाइस सा डैशबोर्ड बन जाएगा जिसमें आपको सारी चीजें दिख जाएंगी। सो एज अ VC यू शुड हैव अ सिंगल डैशबोर्ड, ठीक है। कहीं से भी कुछ भी आए आपको 2-4-5 स्क्रीन के अंदर पूरी यूनिवर्सिटी की सारी पिक्चर आपको चाहिए, अकाउंट्स मेरा इतना है, इतने लोग आज छुट्टी पे हैं, इतने लोग आज ट्रेनिंग पे गए हुए हैं, इतनी क्लासेस सही से चल रही है, एक कंप्लीट यूनिवर्सिटी का डैशबोर्ड जिसको देख के आप सारी डिसीजन मेकिंग कर सके, ठीक है। सो दैट इज द अल्टीमेट ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड देन दैट डैशबोर्ड शुड हैव मल्टीपल लेवल्स, ठीक है। आपके लेवल पे एक है, डीन रजिस्ट्रार अपने अपने कॉलेज लेवल पे एक है, प्रोफेसर के लेवल पे है, टीचर के लेवल पे सारे कोर्सेज आ रहे हैं, स्टूडेंट के लेवल पे है। तो वो एक डैशबोर्ड का जो एक कंप्लीट कंसेप्ट है जो इसके आगे आज सारी गवर्नमेंट भी उसी हिसाब से चल रही है क्योंकि वो एक इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट बन गया है, तो उसके हिसाब से आप सब कुछ डिसीजन मेकिंग में आपका डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम की तरह पूरी यूनिवर्सिटी आगे चले, तो आप देखेंगे कि टाइम एनर्जी और सब जो यहाँ लगा है उसका 10-fold रिजल्ट आपको मिलेगा। वो सो एफर्ट जो आपके IT में लगेंगे वो कहीं ना कहीं एटलीस्ट 10 times आपको उसका रिजल्ट मिलेगा ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। तो ये है।
बहुत सारी चीजें आपने बताई, आगे कोले साहब बताइए हाउ यू वांट दिस ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग टू डेवलप नाउ।
सर एक्चुअली द इन दिस सर द NIC हैविंग द मेजर रोल सर because okay. already they are having the e-office and implementing in the various offices 100% foolproof. But sir, from last 6-7 months, sir, we are continuously touching with the Garje sir and NIC officer. Already, sir, we registered the dbskkv.ac.in domain name from the Arnet as per the NIC suggestion. Later on, sir, for e-signature also we contacted to the SIDAC, sir. Then, but sir, that total implementation cost, sir. So now my view, sir, that Garje sir having a very vital role in this implementing this project with the minimum cost to the State Agriculture University. Sir, my request, sir, Garje sir, sir, already we as per your suggestion, sir, we already the register domain name dbskkvac.in. Already, sir, we are in process to taking the email. On the same domain name, dbskkvac.in, for example, sdsavant vc@ dbskkvac.in, sir. But, sir, implementing yes, sir, cost.
Yes. While deciding your emails and naming conventions, be particular about it. You should have one email for an office. Like, that should be without the personal name. Like VC office है तो वो vc.vc@ आपका वो हो जाएगा, ठीक है। Then आपका है तो जो है, so आपके जो by profile emails हैं वो रहने चाहिए क्योंकि over a period of time वही आगे रहेंगे, आपके personal emails additionally होने चाहिए, ठीक है। So ये जब आप एक central email solution की बात करेंगे तो एटलीस्ट ये इसमें ध्यान रख लेना।
सुदीप जी, already we have registered all our official name, for example, vc dbskkv maharashtra @gov.in. with the government from email ID. Already, sir, we are having this 40 official emails and other up to the root level, assistant professor email with us. Total 126 .gov email with us, sir. But sir, what happened actually while utilizing this email, now they provide the cover software and for accessing to this email, from last 15 days, we are facing a large number of problems, particularly to open these emails also. Because day by day, sir, they're changing their policy without OTP and without something, sir, that email is not opening now. So that we cause the problem, sir, at our level.
What about sir, new domains?
Hello.
You are registered new domain.
Yes, sir. Already, sir, we registered the DBS KKV AC.in with the ARNET as per the suggestion by the NIC, sir, Garje, sir, office, sir.
Sandeep, sir. Sandeep, sir. I am Dr. Shingare from College of Fisheries, Ratnagiri. We are also fishing last 15 days. Our office, ED office, gov.in, it is not working. And we are not able to open the any email last 15 days. We have contacted our university office, AKMU also. They also suggested some suggestions. And then after trying, we are not able to get the our gov.in mail. And there is problem from some NIC. So these are the problems. So we are not able to operate the emails of gov.in.
I wanted to say one thing. This problem is a temporary problem because you have just gone for a Kavach and we are using Kavach since last 6 or 7 months. It is working fine. But anyway, Kole sir, you tell me who are having some problems that I will take up matter from my yes. side to Delhi and I will try to solve that problem.
Yes, sir. Yes.
But it's a temporary problem. Don't worry about it. We are also using Kavach since long.
Yes, Kavach, sir. Kavach system is there. Kavach is there. We are opening Kavach also and simultaneously we are opening the gov.in. But when we are logging using the password, there is some message that you are capsing out and it is not able to open it. So when we inquired, our university told that there is a problem from NIC office and they are solving the problems.
Yes, yes, absolutely right. There was some problem for Kavach. They were struggling last 15 days. Maybe I think fortnight back only. Now it is stable, I think so. But still, if there are problems, we'll read it to solve that problem. I will talk to
yes, sir, the sir, some important email, wo, jo bhi, amara college ka, AD ka jo email hai, kuch bhi hum dekh nahi sakte usme. Please, sir, kare.
No problem. Police, sir, kanche ke problem hai, apan bagu tala.
Yes, sir. Sir, I will report it. Garje, sir, I will report it considering all the problem to you, sir.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, sir.
We'll see that.
Hello.
अभी कोले साहब आपके दो स्पीकर्स yet to give
yes,
their comments.
Sir, Alka madam is ready, sir. He joined, sir. He is ready for deliver the sir lecture.
Yes, sir.
So give our opportunity to.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Sudeep ji, sir. Thank you for the elaborating all these things in the regarding the implementation of the EU office. I request Alka madam to deliver the lectures on the EU extension. Alka madam, please.
Yes, sir. My slides are visible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, madam.
Okay. Bring them to...
Yeah, I am bringing them to slideshow.
Mm-hmm.
So, thank you so much for this opportunity. Basically, I have been given the topic for e-extension. Basically, how the extension activities can be carried out using electronically, which I understood by. So, I would like to share the case study, which we have developed at ISRI. In collaboration with Extension Division ICAR. In this, we have developed one KBK portal and KBK mobile app. So these are the two ICT tools we have developed, which we are using as an extension activity. And these tools are basically used both for the information management as well as for the dissemination of information. KBKs are playing a major role into this. So this is our development team at ISRI, and both the systems has been developed under the guidance of DDG Extension, ADG Extension, and Dr. Adiguru is involved from the Extension Division. I'll share the features which we have developed because everybody know about the structure of these things. So the thing is, because our major focus on this system was KVKs, just to compile or the manage the information which is generated from the KVKs, and it should be properly disseminated to the farmers who are associated with their nearest KVKs. So what we have done is we have created one KVK portal with the name kvk.icr.gov.in, which is a very popular portal. So in this, information about all the KVKs, because there are different users of this portal. KVKs are part of this. They are the information provider for this particular system. So the basic information of all the KVKs, their facilities, the package of practices they are offering. So all these are available in the system. So on the homepage itself, one can look for the KVK. So detail of the person who are the main head of the KVK for that particular district level, this information is available. Similarly, facilities information, which is the KVKs are providing the facility like beekeeping, mushroom farming. So which KVKs are providing details of the same, even their pictures, all these are available. Whenever KVKs are doing any event, so events in the form of the training program they are carrying out, the demonstration they are carrying out. So all this thing is recorded in the system. So they upload the videos, they upload the pictures for the same, so that later in future, if some farmer want to view for that particular information, so that is already available in the system. Along with this, there is agrometeorological advisory, which is available. This advisory is issued from the IMG Pune, and we have linked the API with our system. So one can download the meteorological advisory in the regional language as well as in the English language also. Similarly, all the package of practices are inbuilt. This is available on the system. Along with this, sir, there is another feature which is very important feature, that farmer can send query to the concerned KVKs. They can register with the portal as well as with the mobile app, and they can ask their query. Along with the query, they can even attach the picture, write the description, and that query is sent to the nearest or the attached KVK. So the KVK personal or the subject matter expert, they respond to that particular query. Similarly, the market information, which is from the NIC portal, this is again eMarketNet. This again with the API, this information is linked with the KVK portal, so that information, farmer related information, can be disseminated in a from one place basically. Similarly, there are news which are published from the from the KVKs. This is available on this portal. And we have got a video gallery. In this video gallery, all the useful videos related to farming, this is available in the video gallery. So one can look for that also. Another important thing is, sir, events, whatever like KVKs are doing, their complete details are available on the same. So this is how KVK can be looked onto the KVK portal. One can go to the KVK site. They can look for the state and district, and then the complete information of the KVKs, the profile, their facility detail, their completed event information, their upcoming events information, their contingency plan, package of practices, all related information of the KVKs are available from one place. Similarly, one can view the KVK where it is located on the map also. So this is the feature. Similarly, like facilities also, one can, if one is interested for a particular KVK, what are the facilities available? One can look for the same. Otherwise, the person can search. They can search on the different categories also. They can work, search for the different keywords also. So with all these things, whatever like for beekeeping, for the poultry farming, what are the facilities which are available along with the description, the pictures, along with the contact details, this is available. So this is how one can be benefited. Similarly, for the agrometeorological advisory, which we were looking at. So in this also, like I told, in the regional language as well as in the English, this can be downloaded. Package of practices also for the different categories, crop, horticulture. So all these categories wise, bifurcation of package of practices is there. Similarly, like farmers can send the query. They can write the area in which they want to raise the issue. If there is certain image, there is video, there is audio. So all this can be added. Like for the market information, it has been added with the eNAM portal. Events, like which is very important. Past event which has happened. Ongoing, the future event detail. Whatever will happen. So all this can be, all these are available from this. The beauty of this is, like, information about the events is always available to you. At the same time, whenever there are major events, so there is a special category for the major events. In this, the information is captured. And for this, the complete dashboard is generated in the system in the form of there are different type of reports. Image gallery is generated for the same. Different MIS are reported for the same. So this way, system has the feature that this automatically, this type of dashboard for special events are created along with the different MIS reports, which can be further downloaded. Similarly, sir, that Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan, which was organized, this was very famous. Like Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan 1, 2, and now the 3 going on. For this, we have done a very good work. We have created a dashboard for all these activities. So for this, the complete dashboard, MIS reports, this was made available to the Government of India from this KVK portal. After this, like KVK portal dashboard itself provides all the information about the farmers registered with this. And we have got more than like 80 lakhs farmers, 80 lakhs visitors who have visited this site, and we have more than 7.5 lakhs farmers who are registered with our site. And this is the video gallery. In this, the information is available categorized into different categories. So one can look for a particular category or one can browse through a particular KVK or particular region also. Farmer-centric basically, this is available. So this type of search facilities has been inbuilt on this. So these are some of the features about the dissemination, like what type of information is disseminated and how we can disseminate the information, and the portal has the features. Another very important feature is information addition, basically capturing of the information. Before we go for the capturing of the information or how the information management is taken care, this is the KVK mobile app, which is available at the Google Play Store. This has got more than 50,000 downloads. So this is a very popular app. All the features of the KVK portal, which we have talked about the information dissemination, all are available in the KVK portal mobile app also. So this is thing. Other than this, there are the different users level which has been created. So this is after login, the user has to enter or the select the state, select the district, and then they have to attach themselves to the nearest KVK. So once they attach themselves to the nearest KVK, so this way all the information which we have talked of is available in the KVK mobile app. Like we were talking of, they can ask the queries also, they can send the queries, they can select the commodity type, they can select the commodity name, they can add image, video, or even their audio script also with the description of the problem, and then it is sent through mail. So this automatic email generation or email creation, so all these things are mapped into the these things. Along with the registered farmers or the extension worker who are associated with the app, there is a role for the KVK head also. Like they basically, whatever the queries are directed to them, so they respond to the queries. At the same time, they upload the information for the events, for the package of practices, for the information management. And at the same time, they can broadcast the message also. This is very important part because all the farmers which are registered for that particular KVK, so they can broadcast a particular message or the advisory with the help of this KVK mobile app. So this is how the queries are basically received, and then the queries are forwarded to this thing. So this is how the message can be broadcasted to this. Similarly, we have this home screen for the Atari level users also. For this Atari level users, again, they have the provision that they can see the complete dashboard, like how many queries are received from the Atari level, KVK level, how many are answered, how many are unanswered. So this is a complete dashboard. Similarly, type of dashboard is available at the headquarters also. So this is one aspect we were talking about the information, basically dissemination. Now we talk of the information management part also. One way of information management was the information which was for the farmers or the farming community or for the extension workers. Now, as far as this online reporting mechanism is concerned, because this basically for the e-governance aspect only, this portal was initially envisaged. Because as we know, there are more than 700 KBKs in the NAR system. So they used to send every month the monthly progress report of the same. And this compilation of that information was taking a lot of time and it was a tedious task. So this complete mechanism has been inbuilt into the system that whenever you log in at the KBK portal, so this is how the homepage looks like. So every KBK basically, they fill up the MPR, the monthly progress report of the same. So they fill up the MPR for the same. This MPR goes to the Atari level. So Atari basically, they can view MPR of all the KBKs under them. They can monitor whether who are the defaulter KBKs who have not submitted the same. They can send the email notification to them. At the same time, they can approve or disapprove the information which has been submitted by the KBKs. So this is how a complete monitoring system happens basically in the system, so that all these things are inbuilt into the system for all dashboards. Different kind of graphs are there for better monitoring of the same. So this is in nutshell, I wanted to present that how we are taking care of the e-extension part. So definitely there can be a wider perspective also in different scenarios. But this is in the scenario of KBKs and Ataris. This was the profile given to us from the extension division, and we have done this job. So with this, I thank all of you for giving this opportunity. So I'll be happy to take questions on the same because that will be more relevant.
Madam Amala, we just were interested to know whatever you presented, this platform and dashboard and other things, is a part of KVK portal or?
Yes, sir. They are part of KVK portal. This is one platform we have basically developed for the information dissemination from the KVKs. So all these are part of KVKs. On the KVK portal itself, the mobile app has been created. So both have the same common database. So same way the information is disseminated through mobile app also, and at the same time through portal also.
I mean, suppose our KVKs want to adopt that, they have to make a separate effort or they have to upload?
Already they are part of this, sir. Already they are part of this. All the KVKs are part of this KVK system. Okay. The thing is, I forget to mention one thing. Earlier that feature was not there. The universities can monitor the KVKs who are under them, but now that feature has also been this added, that they can monitor the KVKs under them. So you can also monitor the KVKs under you, and all the KVKs are part of this system.
It means if I go log into KVK portal, I will be able to do all this.
Yes, sir. But that you will be able to do as an extension worker, as a farmer. But if you want special right for the data entry right basically, so we have got a different users for the KVKs. At the same time, for the where the KVKs are situated, for that also we have got a different user category. So we can give you that user category also, through which you can view all the KVKs under your university system. If they are in a location under your university, so you can monitor that.
Yeah, coincidentally, I think Dr. Talati is on the online. Talati sir.
Tiger is there. They are mute.
Unmute,
sir.
Unmute yourself and come.
Yes, there comes.
Ha, sir. Good morning, sir.
Have you heard the presentation? अरोरा मैडम का प्रेजेंटेशन आपने देखा या नहीं देखा?
सर नहीं देखा, मैं अभी जॉइन हुआ सर.
अच्छा, now I wanted to know, that whatever the new platforms or direct login systems which she has made for KVK people,
Yes.
Are you doing it or you are not doing it?
Sir, are you part of KVK portal?
Yes, sir. We are doing it. Regularly we are updating the events.
Because
while your presentation was on, I opened KVK portal.
Yes, sir.
And I saw Roha has given all the details. They are available.
Yes, sir.
In addition to that, what you can suggest them to do?
Yes, if particularly for your university setup, if you want this extension services can be extended beyond this scope of this KVK portal, yes, we will be happy to take it up with your suggestions.
Okay. Good. Theek hai. Probably our, we have two KVKs in two different districts. And some of the KVKs are NGOs and private yes. KVKs. All of them, I think, are following regularly the KVK portal.
Yes, sir. It's mandatory for them.
Mm-hmm. It is mandatory for KVK also. Unless and until we are not updating the data, it should not be reflected in the monthly report.
Yeah, for monthly report they are doing it.
It is most necessary. We have to regularly update the
report. Sir, actually the data, the monthly reports, what the KVK's information they are entering, this some of the information is shared with the portal which has been developed by the Niti Aayog. So yes, we have created an API. So on three parameters, three KPIs, data is already shared to the Niti Aayog dashboard. So yes, this way the portal is linked with the... we'll link with the other government portals also, sir. Even the information which is available in the KVK portal and KVK mobile app, this has been made part of the Kisan Suvidha app also, which yes. has come up from the NIC. So they have also taken the API from us so that they wanted for all the information for the farmers, it should be available at one place. So we are we have developed APIs and we have shared APIs with them also. All the KVK information which is available at the Kisan Suvidha. So it is going from the KVK portal only. So it is like whenever the KVKs, they should keep their information up to date because it is disseminated at various platforms.
Good. Thank you. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.
So much for
thank you, madam. So already Alka madam had explained the details, the KVK, how the in-life services been extended to the, our university also. Sir, Honorable Vishy, sir, our next speaker is Mr. Manoj, sir. He is the Executive Officer from National Cooperative Consumer Federation of India Limited, sir. He is undertaking projects, sir. But, sir, he has gotten some emergency, sir. He is one family member, just before 10 minutes hospitalized, so he left the meeting, sir.
Okay, so we will take him after some time or?
No, sir, no, sir. He is now, sir, in a way of hospital, sir. So maybe probably he will not join, sir, today.
Okay, okay.
Sir, now our sir main focus to implement the office, sir, with the Dr. Garje, sir, with the minimum cost.
Pirse, give it back to Dr. Lakshmikant Garje, sir.
Yes, sir.
And now I would suggest you to conclude what is the takeaway for today's brainstorming. what will be your guidelines to us now?
Thank you. As we have heard from all the people, and as police sir said, ki they already taken domain name also, they registered URL also, they have got emails also. And secondly, I think for you, I think what's their name? I forgot something, no? ICR, they given that suggestion for us how to go about it, how to create the teams. How to get the information with respect to your place. Then secondly, they said about CRU section centralization, how it can be strengthened, how the intelligent person can be kept in that particular, you can say, section of registry. And they said that you should go for training and other things. So training, you don't worry about that. We are here, not all people are same. So we are ready to provide you training. As and when it is required, we are not living in between whenever this implementation is going on. So I think this is more than sufficient what I want to say to you.
Yeah, I would now expect Dr. Kolle.
Yes, sir.
To prepare our plan.
Yes.
How we will go about the implementation of different e-office process in different aspects. Probably even at NIC, you have different modules, or you are a single one which implements everything.
There is single one model. See, basically, I already told you there are two types of e-office available. One is prime and one is light. But what I suggest to you that you should go with the light only, wherein we have only the file movement of your department as well as the KMS. And if you require, you can go for the appraisal system and the Sparrow system afterwards. But initially, you go with this only. And as far as leave and tour is concerned, that for that, we will go with the EHRMS application, which is available with NIC.
Okay.
Sir, I have a question with to Dr. Darje. EHRMS and they are related basically, they can talk to each other, e-office and EHRMS?
See, earlier what happened, e-office was itself containing the leave also, tour also, the PIMS also and Sparrow also. Now okay. What happened, we have made only e-file and KMS in one place, whereas e-tour, e-leave and PIMS, we discarded that and applied into the, we can say, EHRMS. So we are suggesting to go for EHRMS separately.
But whether these two systems can talk to each other, in terms of data exchange?
Data, see, both the datas are different only, na, because employee master is same for both the places.
Yes.
So there is no other interaction between them then.
Yeah, only employee master is common.
That is the same for both.
Sir, I request Honorable Vice Chancellor the final concluding remarks.
Yeah, well, now you wrap it up. First of all, I thank all the participants, Dr. Garje Saab, Dr. Marwa, Dr. Arora Madam. In between, our Sandeep Patil came in and went. I mean, all of them, they have contributed substantially. Probably the purpose of today's brainstorming has been at least to some extent achieved. And now all this information will help us to prepare how we are going about it, implementation part in coming days. We will prepare our targets, reasonable targets for implementing various softwares. And let us hope that we will make a good progress in coming days. And we will be able to implement office in such a way that our usage on computer will increase and usage of printers will reduce.
Yes, sir.
And that was our one of the objective. And then, of course, the issue of transparency, Garje Saab has explained. And we will be able to have that transparency, but during the implementation. So yes. Thank you all, one and all. And we will come back to you whenever we require some information. And hope you will help us accordingly.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. Sir, I thank you to the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Savan, sir, for completely attend this session, sir. It's a busy schedule, sir. I am thankful to all my director, Dr. Bhaveji, sir, Dr. Hardanta, sir, Dr. Narkar, sir, controller, university engineer, registrar, and all my faculty member. I especially thankful to the guest lecturer, sir, Dr. Garje, sir. He is very busy schedule, sir, from NIC, and he is attending all the sessions and very truthful remarks on this, sir. I am thankful, sir, Dr. R.C. Goyal, sir, then Dr. Sudeep ji and Dr. Alka ji, sir, contributing their views, implementing the university towards the e-office and other ICT tools in the university. Sir, with the permission of the chair, sir, I
forgot to make a mention of Dr. Goyal, sorry.
Yes.
He also contributed a lot.
Yes, sir. Sir, with the permission of the chair, sir, I conclude this session, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Namaskar.
Thanks.
link.